go as St. Andrews.
That defensive line takes on number 61, Luke Signacic. At defensive line, number 52, P.J. Collins. At linebacker, number 43, Pierre Lemieux. At linebacker, number 5, Evan Shergold. At linebacker, number 59, Marcus Moore. At linebacker, number 35, Gordon White. At defensive back, number 10, Liam Gripple. At defensive back, number 22, Duncan Colson. At defensive back, number 24, Mark Delfatti. At defensive back, number 29, Kevin Searle. And at defensive back, number 44, Eric Mauti. And the head coach of the Cary Blues is Frank Trentadue. And now, the starting offense for the 2011-2012 back-to-back defending CISAA champions, your St. Andrews College Saints! At center, number 58, Riley Fisher! At left guard, number 55, Duncan Robertson. At right guard, number 54, Adam Ashby. At left tackle, number 40, Jonathan Harvey. And at right tackle, team captain, number 56, Cody McMillan. At receiver, number 11, Bryce Johnson. At slot back, number 9, Austin Hassani. At receiver, number 5, Daniel Cummings. At slot back, number 8, Ryan Keys. And at slot back, team captain, number 88, Zach Marcus. At running back, number 28, Jonathan Femicore. And finally, your quarterback and team captain, number 12, Chris Merchant! The head coach of the Saints is Lenger. We ask you to please rise and remove your baseball caps for the playing of the Canadian National Anthem.
All right, welcome to homecoming here. Beautiful St. Andrews College, state-of-the-art facility. The Saints and the Cary Blues getting set for kickoff. Moments away, and luckily for all the fans here at St. Andrews, the weather cooperating earlier today. The junior teams met, and it was sloppy. This field was obviously facing some pretty tough elements as it was coming down pretty hard. But the weather cooperating now as the Saints and the Cary Blues get set for kickoff moments away. Earlier in the preseason, the Saints took care of business against the Lucas Vikings from London, Ontario, my alma mater. And they're ready for homecoming, their first game of the year, as the two-time CISAA champs get set to receive the opening kickoff. And should be a very exciting season. I know Coach Len Gurr, very excited. Chris Merchant, who will be going to Buffalo, is going to do some very special things for the Saints team. We're going to find out just how the season opens as the opening kickoff is moments away. We'll be joined by Dave Stewart, who's the coach of the junior team. He'll be doing the color for us here as the Cary Blues get set to kick off and the Saints will receive.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Dave, how are you?
I'm doing great, thanks so much.
Weather a little bit more cooperative than the earlier junior game. Here we go, opening kickoff. It is fielded at their own 10. And a very good kick, look at this! Right off the bat, the Saints will have great field position at their own 50-yard line, great return.
Tremendous run, tremendous.
Chris Merchant now will take the field at his own 50. Well, the Saints open up this year. What are in your opinion are the keys here for this team to, I guess, be three-time CISAA champs? As offensively, I know they are stacked.
Stacked offensively for sure. Key to the success here has got to be the defense. We had a solid defense last year, and yep. I'm hearing good things about the defensive core this year. You know, with a backstop like Chris Merchant, you know you're going to have some offensive success, along with some key offensive linemen as well. And, of course, you can't say enough about a kid like Jonathan Femi Cole.
Yeah, absolutely.
But, of course, they really do need to tighten up the D a little bit from last year, perhaps, and I think when they do that, they've got great chance of repeating.
Going into this game, I thought we'd see a steady dose of the ground game based on the weather, but it has cooperated, which will allow Chris Merchant to sort of air it out. Now, he played in Calgary, so he's sort of used to that wet ball and the cold conditions, the wet conditions, so he'll feel right at home if it does start raining a little bit.
Absolutely. Absolutely he will. But you're right. You're absolutely right. The conditions this morning were atrocious for football, so well, it's cleaned itself up a little bit.
Well, here we go. First down, Saints, their own 50-yard line. Chris Merchant in the shotgun to open up. We start with a run, and it is a nice run. A first down run, but a flag on the play.
Flag on the play.
Late flag.
Femi Cole powering his way through.
But it looks like it is coming back, unfortunately, for the Saints. Yeah, it is. That'll bring up a first and long as that first down, unfortunately, wiped out. Holding on the Saints. So that pushes them back to their own 40. First and long, and on a first and long play, Coach, you know, you figure maybe this will get our first opportunity to see Chris Merchant air it out.
I think it's possible. Yeah. I think it's possible. Certainly a great way to start, but I know Coach Kerr likes to limit the penalties.
Absolutely. He can't like a holding penalty on the first play from scrimmage.
No, not at all.
All right, first and 20, and it is our first pass. It is an incomplete pass.
That was to Zach Marcus.
One of the team captains, Zach Marcus, a little high. Sure Marcus would like that one back, but second down and long now for the Saints.
It's a tough go, of course. These guys are amped up. It's their own homecoming.
Yep.
They're excited. We've got hundreds of people here, so may take a couple of plays for these guys to settle down a little bit and get in their groove.
Early first quarter, 14 minutes to go in the second and 20 now for the Saints from their own 40. And Merchant, you got to expect, we'll be airing this one out now in the shotgun again. play action from Merchant. Doesn't have anything.
Nothing.
He'll have to run here, and it does not have much at all. Merchant hit hard at his own 40. No gain on
no
the
gain
play.
At all.
That'll bring up third down for the Saints, and the punt team on the field early for Coach Gurr.
Yep. It's unfortunate. It almost had lead blocking by Femi Cole there, which could have turned into some success, but didn't look like Merchant had too much downfield, unfortunately.
That's why penalties are killer. I mean, you get the first down run on the first play, and all of a sudden the hold comes and the flag comes in late, and now we're seeing the negative for St. Andrews, forced a punt here, third and 20.
Absolutely.
And not a great
not
kick
a
either.
Great kick.
That'll go out of bounds right around midfield. So great field position for the Cary Blues on their first possession.
Absolutely. And this is a solid team as well. And if you don't bury them deep, they're going to make you pay, that's for sure. Or they potentially could.
Yeah, they got a very short field here. They'll take over right around midfield. So an early penalty for the Saints, a bad punt, and not the start you want here homecoming for St. Andrews.
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. But it's early. We'll see how this this defensive core reacts.
All right, for the Saints, defensively, this is what you said. They got to make some plays, and they're going to have an opportunity right here.
Absolutely.
Calvin Vaughn at quarterback for the Cary Blues. Vaughn.
Outside.
Yeah, that's an easy completion, and that'll be close to first down, but nice stop by the Saints to prevent the first down there on first and 10. Brings up second down and short.
Second and short, yep. So it's exciting to be here. I have to tell you, this is my first venture into the world of radio. So
very nice.
Very exciting.
You did a great job with the intros
there. Well, thanks very much.
That was awesome.
If my voice cracks a little bit, you'll understand why.
All good. Yeah, looking forward to this. Should be a really good football game.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's nice when you have a homecoming game and you're tested right off the bat. And we expect certainly St. Mike's to come in here and give St. Andrews everything they can handle.
Oh, absolutely. Without a doubt.
Calvin Vaughn at quarterback. Second play is a first down
first
throw.
Down.
That'll set up the Cary Blues in Saints territory.
Absolutely.
At the St. Andrews 35.
35.
So that's two for two now for Calvin Vaughn, looking good under center for the Cary Blues.
Absolutely, a nice toss right down the middle, and big gain.
So that's the first official first down of the ball game. The first Saints first down was wiped out due to the holding penalty. And once again, Calvin Vaughn in shotgun. Looks like this guy wants to be a gunslinger homecoming in St. Andrews.
Yes.
Here we go, third straight pass. And that's a drop.
Incomplete.
That's a ball that should have been caught by Rayshon Smith.
Absolutely.
Big break there for the Saints. Brings up second down. You go on the road, you play another team at their homecoming, you got to make plays when they're there to be made. And that's a bad drop by Rayshon Smith.
That's unfortunate. Right in his hands. Nice toss right through the middle again, and the gunslinger, he's ready to go today.
Got to admit, I like what I see out of Calvin Vaughn early.
Absolutely.
This kid looks like he's the real deal.
Absolutely.
Well, Vaughn again in shotgun. Another pass coming here as Vaughn throws it, and this pass is complete.
Complete.
And it is now, looks to be a first down. He got the forward progress. Nice play by Kayon Grant, the receiver.
He just danced his way to a first down.
Yeah,
that was excellent.
That's a nice play by Grant. He was caught the ball short of the first down. A couple Saints were there, but Grant makes the play, gets the first down yardage, and here we go. The Cary Blues in business at the Saints. Looks like they're 25.
25, yeah. They are really working the field well. Looks like the corner just overcompensated a little bit, allowed them to get outside and gain the first down.
Well, Calvin Vaughn again looks like he wants to keep throwing this ball.
Absolutely.
We haven't seen any running game yet from the Cary Blues. And another pass.
Another pass.
And this one's knocked out. That's a nice play.
That's Angeles Prattis up
Prattis,
the middle.
Yeah, Prattis,
knocking
the linebacker,
the ball down.
Made a nice play.
Absolutely.
In coverage.
It would appear the strategy early on is letting the QB throw the ball. It's been a great success so far.
Well, we haven't seen what the Cary Blues can do on the ground just yet.
Absolutely.
Clock still moving here. 10 minutes to go, first quarter. No score. Both teams have had one possession. The Saints went two and out on their opening possession after a holding penalty negated a first down on their first play from the scrimmage. And here come the Cary Blues right now from the Saints 25. Calvin Vaughn again.
In the shotgun.
Gonna throw the ball. Going in zone.
Going deep.
He's got a guy. He drops the ball.
Oh, my
Incomplete. Goodness. Wow, Matthew Crocker. He'll want that one back up. That'll haunt him in his dreams tonight. Crocker, that hit him in the numbers.
Absolutely.
And a drop pass. Big break for the Saints defense.
That was an absolutely tremendous throw. Right in the numbers.
I got to say, Calvin Vaughn is pinpoint accuracy, but
absolutely.
His receiver's two drops.
That was a beautiful throw.
Sure
that
was.
I shirked a little bit. I pretty much felt that was a guaranteed touchdown. But
yeah, that ball's in the air. I'm thinking 6 points.
He had his man beat on the outside.
It was
on a line. And unfortunate for the Cary Blues, but fortunate for the Saints, I guess.
This will set up a field goal attempt as the Cary Blues look to get on the board here. And their kicker, Duncan Colson, will attempt the field goal. Kick is up, and the kick is no good.
Kick is wide.
Kick is wide left. That'll be a single point for the Cary Blues. So they open the scoring, but, man, that's a wasted opportunity. A drop, touchdown pass, then a missed field goal. So you got to feel like St. Andrews pretty lucky to be down just 1-0 after that Cary Blues drive.
Absolutely. That was a really strong drive. I think if you're St. Mike's right now, you're feeling pretty good about your first series. It's unfortunate they didn't come away with any points for them, but I think if you're the Saints, you've got to start hit the reset button, and now we got to move the ball.
Absolutely, and they did move the ball in their first play. It was a bad holding penalty and a late flag. I know Lenger probably didn't like that flag.
Oh, absolutely
flag.
Not.
But
absolutely
here we go,
not.
Saints second possession, and we will see Chris Merchant, who, of course, is the all-world St. Andrews quarterback. This kid is the real deal.
Absolutely.
And, there's a flag.
Oh,
it looks like some
finally,
early movement there. This will be a first down run, so probably the flag offside on the Cary Blues will be declined. First down for St. Andrews.
Late flag as well. I'm not sure what that one's for.
We work out the penalties, and yes, it is offside was the initial flag.
Yes.
On St. Mike's, so this will mean that the St. Andrews Saints will have their first down of the ball game at their own 50-yard line.
And a nice run by Jonathan Femi Cole as well.
Yeah, he didn't look like he had much initially, and he found a seam.
He's a powerhouse, I'll tell you.
And there's an extra penalty as well here on the Cary Blues, so that will put it in Cary Blues territory now as St. Mike's will have the ball at the, St. Andrews at the St. Mike's 45.
St. Mike's 45, yep.
Chris Merchant again in shotgun here. And it's a quarterback keeper and close to a first down.
Yep. If not a first down.
Good run, Chris Merchant.
Absolutely.
How athletic is he?
Wow, he's very athletic. And I have to say, he's an absolutely tremendous young man, got to know him over the past couple of years. He's a true star in every sense. It's wonderful to have him at the school. But he's a gamer.
He is.
On game day, he is a gamer. He's
got a great
sense of humor, but on game day, he's the real deal.
There he goes. That run by Merchant will set up a second and short for the Saints as they are at the St. Mike's 36. And Merchant passing here on second and short. He's got a guy wide open.
Touchdown, St. Andrews. That was Ryan Keyes going deep.
How open
it
was Ryan
wide
Keyes.
Open. Obviously, the St. Mike's Cary Blues felt they were going to hand off to.
There is a flag, though. It looks like it's coming back.
Oh my goodness.
A
little too excited there.
Yeah, a little premature celebration. This play is coming back, unfortunately.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
That's a second terrible penalty. And Coach Gurr is just stewing on the St. Andrews sidelines.
He is steaming.
Wow.
I'll tell you, that was a beautiful play. They really did feel that Femi Cole was going to get the ball and just punch it through for a first down.
Well, this will now set up, unfortunately, it is a first down, but This will be a first and long. Well, the bad break there for the Saints. I didn't see the penalty.
I didn't either.
I was watching the wide receiver go wide open in the end zone.
I feel bad for our alumni at home.
Yeah.
And all the others who are watching who are St. Andrews fans.
It's
we were
a
very
hold.
Excited.
Yeah.
It's a hold.
Well, you know what? Hey, listen. This is for all the St. Andrews fans that couldn't make it out,
right? That's
right.
That's
right. Kids playing,
right.
And you know, so obviously they want the excitement.
That's
they had
right.
a touchdown, unfortunately, called back. They ended up second and long after the hold. Chris Merchant again in the shotgun. He's got a guy, but play. That could be pass interference, though.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a pass interference call. That was a nice ball. Really nice ball to number five, Daniel Cummings. We'll wait and see what the official call is, but it looks pretty clear.
I'm assuming that's pass interference. You see a flag thrown over there.
Yeah.
Didn't look like it was offensive, so that will set up. It is pass interference on St. Mike's. That'll set up St. Andrews with a first down.
Yes, absolutely. Yep, first down.
All right, well, penalties a big part of this first quarter, aren't they, Dave?
We're just working some things out here, I guess. Everyone needs to settle down just a little bit, but that was a pretty obvious one. I didn't see the hold earlier, but that...
No, I didn't see the hold either, but that pass interference you knew, especially when the flag comes there, you know that's going to be called every time. Good throw by Chris Merchant. He had a guy, he threw to double coverage.
That's right, it was double coverage, absolutely. He options,
and Merchant takes off here.
Own.
Merchant hit, and again, close to a first down for the Saints.
That's... You know, one of the special things about Chris is, as you'll see him, he dropped his shoulder into a guy there as opposed to sliding stay away from any contact. He is a gamer, and he's gonna get everything he can when he runs with that ball.
Well, it's great experience for him, too, obviously playing in this program. They've had so many great players recently that have gone on to play CIS, play, you know, in the U.S. I know Chris is going to go to Buffalo.
Absolutely,
And this program will certainly have him ready, not just for be a football player, but to be a man as well. That's what St. Andrews does.
Absolutely. And he's once again in shotgun, it looks like.
Yeah, no, Merchant. Yeah. Both quarterbacks like to throw the ball here. We're not going to see a lot of running in this,
this is,
homecoming game. Merchant again, look at the
and
throw.
He's got the ball.
Merchant
there
will take
goes.
Off. And Merchant,
and he's, going.
He's got daylight. Merchant all the way down to the 1 yard line.
What a great run.
Well, that'll set up the Saints now. First and goal for St. Andrews. Great run, Chris Merchant.
He's a smart young man. He sees the field so well. And he saw that there was a gap there, and he just exploited it dramatically. It was fantastic.
It was great, Dave. We see the hole up here, but for him to see it on the field.
For sure.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
So first and goal, Saints. They're at the 2 yard line now, for 2 yards away from taking a 6-1 lead here as Chris Merchant lines up under center. See if we see some running plays here. It's been a lot of passing, but. First and goal, we'll see what the play call is.
I wouldn't be surprised if number 28 grabs the ball this time around.
Well, Michael Carroll calls for the run, and there it is, touchdown Saints.
And this one, I'm viewing the field, there are no red flags.
No,
so
that's
for all the St. Andrews fans, this is indeed a touchdown.
Yeah, we can guarantee that this will not be called back. And the Saints take a 6-1 lead. Nice run.
Absolutely.
As, you know, it was made it look pretty easy on that drive.
For sure. And they benefited from that a couple of penalties. But, you know, they exploited things when they needed to. And Merchant looked way more casual, way more in the game on this series than in the first series. Although, mind you, he didn't look out of the game.
No,
in the first
that holding
you.
Penalty
the holding
probably
penalty took the
anytime
lead out of the
anytime you have first and 20 in your opening series, extra point is no good.
No good.
Very low extra point, and we've seen the kicking game struggle on both ends as the Cary Blues missed the short field goal, and now St. Andrews misses the extra point. But there's a flag on the play.
There's a flag on the play. I'm not sure we'll get the call
it's
here
on
in a
St.
moment.
It's on St. Andrews here. Yep. So the extra point will not be good, and the Saints have a 6-1 lead.
5 minutes and 41 seconds left in the first quarter, and the Saints came out and responded very well to a really strong opening drive by the Cary Blues.
They are going to get a chance to kick this again, actually. The penalty now is offsetting, so it's going to give St. Andrews a chance to get this extra point and go up 7-1. Can't be any worse than the first kick.
No, I would agree with that.
Low snap, and well, here we go. They're going to have to go for two. And they don't have it.
Not quite.
No. So
almost made something out of nothing, but not quite. Zach Marcus takes us down to the 2. It was a seemingly a broken play. It looks like he bobbled the ball. on the snap.
Yeah, that was obviously on the snap. And you know what? It is a wet ball. It was raining here. It's obviously not raining very hard, but it is certainly drizzling. And it looks like they're going to get another chance to kick this. And this will be a third opportunity for the extra point.
Well, this is very interesting.
You don't see this very often, do you, Dave?
No, not at all. No, I'm quite surprised at this. I'm not. He looks like the having some words with the St. Mike's lineman.
Yeah, well, they're going to get a third opportunity here for the extra point, and it could be 7-1 in a second. Here we go. Let's see. This kick is good. There we go. It's 7-1 for the Saints.
All right. Well, that
third time's a charm.
Absolutely, absolutely. What the, that was an interesting. Sequence. Into that series, interesting sequence of events.
Well, you know what, though? A very good second drive for St. Andrews, and they did everything well. They ran the ball well. We saw Merchant throw the ball. We saw Merchant take off a couple times and run for first downs. This is exactly what I'm sure Len Gurr and his offensive coordinator, Michael Carroll, looking for, a very balanced offense to keep the Cary Blues defense, guessing, not knowing what's coming.
I think it's been the success that this team has had over the last few years, in that they don't have to rely entirely on the run game or the pass game. They've got strong offensive linemen.
Yep.
They've got so many weapons at their disposal. It makes it really difficult for the opposition to know what's going to happen and to defend against it, frankly.
Well, you know what? In any time, any football team is one-dimensional. It makes them very easy to defend. I mean, we see this all the time in CIS, in the NFL, in U.S. college football. If you know what that other team is going to do, it's very easily defended. I mean, you look at what happened on Monday Night Football and Chip Kelly and a lot of things that Philadelphia did early. All of a sudden, teams are making adjustments, and I know that that's what St. Andrews wants to do, is keep other defenses off balance here as they kick off from midfield after the penalty that happened on the Cary Blues made the kickoff a little shorter, but a good return for the Cary Blues as they take it out to their own 32-yard line. That's where they will set up shop as their last drive. Very efficient moving the ball. A couple of drops certainly hurting their quarterback, Calvin Vaughn.
Well, it'd be interesting to see what they come out with, whether they stay in the shotgun and continue to throw the ball, which they found great success, or whether they'll try to mix things up a little bit and keep us guessing.
Well, here we go. First down, Cary Blues at their own 32. It's 7-1 Saints. This is the second drive for St. Mike's.
And we're in the shotgun again.
Yeah, they like this formation.
Absolutely,
do they not?
Absolutely. But if it's working, why not, right?
Well, we are going to see the first running play now by the Cary Blues, and it's for a very short gain. Good job by the St. Andrews defense to sniff that out.
Absolutely. Looks like almost all the defensive line were on that that play there. They gang tackled in that one for sure.
Absolutely. So second and I guess 7 or 8 here now for the Cary Blues. And I would certainly expect Calvin Vaughn to go back to throwing the ball.
I would expect it as well.
After a second and long here.
I would expect it as well.
Audible here as Vaughn looks at his wrist and some of the play calls on there. Let's see if we get some noise from this St. Andrews crowd here when St. Mike's is on offense.
There he is. Yeah.
That's a short pass, but a nice run after the catch. And a missed tackle and a first down.
Looks like a first
down,
absolutely.
For St. Mike's. So Cary Blues move the sticks on drive number 2.
Was a nice pass. That was decent coverage on the outside, but he was able to get the first down.
Get by the first tackle. Obviously, that's the key. And I know when you coach the junior team, and when you're coaching up, your defense, is how important is it to make sure that the first guy there is the guy that makes that play?
You know, we experienced that this morning for sure, and that's something we need to work on the juniors this week. First man's there, but not quite making the tackle.
Right. Oh, another pass
again,
here is Calvin Vaughn.
Wide open.
Oh, he's got a guy wide open. That's a long gain deep into Saints territory.
That was Rayshon Smith with the reception and a very nice gain.
Great run after the catch, too. Oh, Rayshon Smith making a big play there. And, you look at that first drive. Calvin Vaughn had two receivers drop passes. That could have been big gains. This case, his receiver bails him out with a nice catch, and they are in business, are the Cary Blues. They have the ball deep at almost red zone territory here, the 21-yard line of St. Andrews.
Saints have their work cut out for them again. Let's see how the defense can respond.
Now Calvin Vaughn looking to throw again, it looks like. And that's what's obviously had a lot of success for St. Mike's. Another throw, and this one incomplete. Two guys there in coverage, no flag on the play. I know that some of the St. Mike's fans below us were looking for a flag, but
they don't necessarily
happen.
Agree with the non-call.
No.
They do not agree. And, you know, it was those ones are always close.
Yep.
And receivers, or sorry, the defensive backs and quarterbacks have really tough jobs to do when they know the ball's coming and they know they need to make contact, and sometimes they're a little early. That one looked maybe a little early, but you know what? We appreciate
ball
the non-call.
Ball was low, though.
Ball
as well,
was low,
right?
and it really wasn't probably his worst ball of the day.
Now Calvin Vaughn now second down. We'll have a guy, and again his receiver drops the ball as that is dropped by Rayshon Smith, who made the great play
earlier.
Earlier in this drive, but there he drops it. That'll set up another field goal attempt here for the Cary Blues as they try to close the deficit to 7-4, but of course their first field goal not very close. It was wide left. We'll see how this one turns out.
Another decent drive for sure. Again, that play by Rayshon Smith was a fantastic play. They just can't seem to capitalize at this moment, so they're gonna keep plugging away, I'm sure. See if they can put some more points on the board here.
Oh, Courtney, who of course was the old head coach here, now the defensive coordinator, had to like the stops in the red zone both times for the Saints, but this field goal is good, so that will get the Cary Blues to within 3 points, 7-4 Saints, as after a terrible first kick, this one right down the middle, good kick, and that does get the Cary Blues to within 3 points here, 2:37 to go in quarter number one.
See, looking down here at the fans, I think you're right in that we need to get these guys a little bit more fired up on the game and so on.
Well, absolutely. You know, you got to have a home field advantage,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And this is a great facility. St. Andrews has great fans. They are lined up here, and they're standing on the track, as it is certainly a nice crowd, but pretty quiet crowd. Maybe the weather having something to do with that. A lot of umbrellas, and you know, we got a little more noise from these St. Andrews passionate fans here. Whenever, of course, St. Mike's has the ball on offense.
Absolutely. Well, it was interesting. I was trying to make my way up to the booth to get things started, and I ran into probably 10 to 15 of my former students. And
very nice.
I'll tell you, it's a wonderful day. It's great to see everyone come back, and it's exciting. It's an exciting day for football. It's too bad the weather wasn't a little bit better, but, you know, at the same time, it's not pouring on us right now.
No, exactly. This doesn't really, I mean, I don't think this weather really changes what either team wants to do on offense. I think both teams, I mean, you're seeing both teams are having no problem throwing
Agreed.
The ball, right?
Agreed, yeah. And I don't think it doesn't seem and that the receiver should have any trouble catching the ball. But
good point. Well, the Cary Blues kick off, and the Saints, another decent return. They will take over just shy of their own 30-yard line. And, first down for the Saints. Up by 3, 7-4 is your score. Saints scoring on their last possession. And, again, both quarterbacks have really, really impressed me. We know all about the Saints quarterback, Chris Merchant, but, you know, looking at Calvin Vaughn, I see a guy who has a potential to move the ball and keep the Cary Blues in this game if he continues to throw the ball as well as he is.
Absolutely, absolutely. I couldn't agree with you more.
All right, first down Saints here at their own 29. Or call it 30, very close to the 30. Chris Merchant in shotgun will throw. There's a flag on the play, and Merchant's going to be taken down. No,
no,
he gets out of it. Wow.
Free.
That is another flag, though. Probably a hold on St. Andrews. But, man, Chris Merchant looked to be sacked a couple of times.
Absolutely.
But, man, he's got that escapability. Houdini out there at quarterback for St. Andrews.
Zach Marcus, number 88, laid down a huge block.
This will come back, though.
Yes,
anytime you see a flag when the quarterback is running, 99 times out of 100, that will be a hold.
Yeah. I can't say that I saw the hold, but I'm with you. It would be I would be shocked if it wasn't a hold.
Yeah,
that's
it's coming
sure.
back. Yeah. St. Andrews is moving back. So this will bring up a first and long here. And this was just like their first play from scrimmage, right? They had that first down run, and it got called back. It brought up a first and 20. The Saints weren't able to convert that. Always tough. First and 20, I mean, what do? You try and get back the penalty yards in the first play, Coach?
That's a good question. I'm not sure here. I mean, I think, you know, when you look at all the weapons that they have, you got to think that Merchant's probably going to step back in the pocket and try and at least gain the yards back, if not try to see one of his wide guys and break free.
A couple penalties here against St. Andrews will make this a very, very long first down, as the first down markers are at the 40, and they now have the ball about the 20. So first and 20 for the Saints. We'll see what Merchant can do here.
See if ball hand off to Femi Cole.
Oh, Cole,
Femi,
good
breaks free up
Cole,
the middle.
Cole is gone. Unbelievable.
Untouched up the middle. Jonathan Femi Cole. Touchdown.
First and 20, and Cole goes the distance.
That was impressive. That was impressive.
That was a flag late. Another flag land. I'm seeing enough of these flags, Dave.
I must say, I saw him in the end zone shaking hands with some of the fans, and the flag went. So
flag,
I'm not sure if it's
celebration
after
penalty
celebration,
or, yeah,
perhaps. I'm not sure.
Unsportsmanlike. We'll see what the call is. But yeah, Cole was gone. I mean, right after he broke that initial tackle, there was no one close to him.
It would seem that's after the play. I didn't see it. I didn't see the flag get thrown until he was coming out of the end zone.
You got to say, the referee's a little bit flag happy today. just being frank here, I'll be honest with you.
You know, I don't disagree.
Okay.
I have to admit to you, when you asked about what I would do in first and 20, part of me was thinking, you know, I might give the ball to Femi Cole.
And I didn't say that,
and I wish I had said that, because that would have made me sound really knowledgeable.
Well, he's been great, Jonathan Femi Cole, and he goes the distance, and the touchdown is good. The penalty, I'm assuming, is unsportsmanlike for a celebration call
after.
But this will give the Saints an opportunity to kick the extra point and to go up 14-4.
That was just an impressive run by Jonathan Femi Cole, but I have to say, the offensive line did an outstanding job of clearing out some space, and he just flew right up in the middle. When he got to the 50-yard line, he was gone, untouched. Beautiful play.
Yeah, great call. First and 20 from your own 20. And Femi Cole finds daylight. And the Saints will kick the extra point and will go up 14-4. So three possessions for St. Andrews. Their first one, they have a holding penalty, which creates a first and 20. They don't get a first down. They're forced to punt. But since then, two possessions, two touchdowns. This offense is rolling, Dave.
They are looking absolutely tremendous. I have to say, I couldn't be more impressed. I'm normally standing down there with the alumni, so I don't get a chance to see the game at this vantage point. So this is really exciting.
It's a great vantage point. We're right here at midfield, and you can certainly see as everything develops. Hello, welcome to St. Andrews Homecoming.
Yes,
Dave
yes,
Stewart and Eric
yes.
Cohen with you. And we're very happy to be here. Certainly very
Absolutely.
Happy with how this first quarter is going. The Saints with back-to-back touchdown possessions and looking great.
Absolutely tremendous on behalf of the Saints. I must say there's been some positive stuff for the Cary Blues as well. And we'll see what they can come up with here. But I'll tell you, three possessions, two touchdowns.
Yep.
They ran that ball very well. And of course, two key players, Chris Merchant, Jonathan Femi Cole, look absolutely tremendous at this point.
What can you tell me about Femi Cole? We talked a lot about Merchant. This Femi Cole is certainly a baller.
Femi Cole is a quiet young man, but he's super nice. And I'll tell you, this kid is committed. You walk down the hall, he always says hello. He's got few things to say. He's not the most outgoing, gregarious young man, but I tell you, he's a wonderful young guy, and he works hard.
Well, you have to. And, I mean, if you play football with what is expected of you academically, on the practice field, game day, I mean, it's an ultimate commitment. And everyone who's playing today has made a lot of sacrifices to be here today. And that's why it's so great to watch these kids and watch the hard work that goes into the entire week get put on display on this football field here, homecoming for St. Andrews, as the Cary Blues will now take over. Again, a pretty good kickoff return. We're seeing some nice special teams returns from both teams.
Yeah, decent field position for the Cary Blues now. I wouldn't be shocked if we saw them go into shotgun once again and start throwing the ball. You know, it's nice to see some of the junior players come up in the ranks into the varsity program as well. You know, guys like Liam Joyner, who I coached a couple of years ago. Great young guy,
yep.
Doing really well out there on defense. Riley Fisher as well. All kinds of them, and these are just solid young men, and they're doing very well. And of course, Lenger's program, with all his coaches, is second to none.
False start by the Cary Blues. We'll set up a first and 15 now for them. And, yeah, I mean, that's the thing is for you, it's got to feel really special for you because you've coached a lot of these kids,
yeah.
And you've seen them grow up, and you've seen them really mature into the men they've become.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Dave Stewart, of course, is the head coach of the junior team, and very happy to have him in the booth with me as we watch St. Andrews. And, of course, St. Andrews, you know, what can you say about this team the last couple of years under Coach Gurr? They've won the CISAA 2 years in a row, and they got a great chance to do it for a third straight year here as they're up 14-4 late in the first quarter. Cary Blues now with a pass, almost a first down throw, as Dylan Ormescher catches the ball just shy of the 50-yard line on first and 50. Referees, now they're saying it's going to be second and short. Second and inches for the Cary Blues.
Nice pass right up the middle. Great reception. Again, they've got some tools as well.
Well, I like their passing game. I really do. We haven't seen much of their running game. But, you know, passing-wise, they've been able to keep some of the DBs from St. Andrews on their heels here.
Without a doubt.
All right, this could be the final play of the first quarter. Could see a run here, we do, but a flag on the play.
Flags on the play.
That will be a first down run if it stands, but that's probably going to come back on a false start, I'm assuming.
Yeah, I would say so as well. We'll wait for the call,
yep.
But it seems as though that's what's going to be happening.
And the referee's continually having to dry off the ball. It is a wet ball. It was raining a lot worse earlier today. Now just drizzling, but a wet field. But, man, this field turf, I mean, it's outstanding.
Yeah, it's absolutely wonderful. This is, you know, it's to coach on this field. Of course, I've never played on it. But to coach on this field is wonderful. Just the support that the school has from its alumni is tremendous. This is the Ewell Family Athletic Complex. And, I mean, if you're a football player and you have the opportunity to play on this field, it is tremendous.
Well, Dave, the penalty was on the Cary Blues, which brings up now a second and six.
Second and six.
And this will be the final play of the first quarter, barring a penalty.
And there may, in fact, be a penalty.
Oh, we've seen a lot of penalties. We have. That red flag has not been a stranger to the field.
Back to pass.
Again, Calvin Vaughn back to pass. He's got a guy, and he's got a
first down
throw. Yeah, that's a great throw. A great catch by Matthew Crocker, making the play. And Crocker seemed to have been defended well, but he makes the play, and that's a first down. Bo Zhang was there for the Saints, but couldn't get a hand on that ball.
Bo Zhang had decent coverage on the outside there. It looked as though he was going to come back and try and grab that ball, but it was a nicely thrown ball right in the hands of the receiver. Well done.
Yeah, I'm becoming a fan of old number 12 here, Calvin Vaughn. I like the balls that are coming out of his hand. He is, you know, if it weren't for a couple of drops, this would be a closer game. He really is a gunslinger back there, and he's the real deal. I think St. Mike's has themselves a pretty good quarterback.
Oh, absolutely. I wish I knew a wee bit more about him,
yeah.
Whether he was in grade 12 or was a younger student, but I'll tell you, he is throwing the ball very well today.
Second quarter underway here now at homecoming for St. Andrews. The Cary Blues, the visitor here, and the visitors are down by 10, but they are driving. They have the ball at the St. Andrews 35 after that first down throw.
Got Calvin Vaughn in the shotgun once again.
That's where he's
that's
his wheelhouse.
Yeah, exactly.
And another throw, and this one also complete. And that's a nice catch again. This one, Matthew Crocker. Matthew Crocker, a big part of this offense for the Cary Blues, making the grab, and I believe that is another first down.
And Ben Thompson,
it is.
On, as the cornerback there, did a really nice job. Great reception, but Ben was right there to take his man down. That's all you can ask for, I think,
yep.
In those circumstances.
Well, when your quarterback is throwing the ball as well as Calvin Vaughn is, I mean, that's all you can do. You're right. If you're there, make sure you get the first guy to make a tackle. Here we are going to see a rare running play for the Cary Blues. This one doesn't go anywhere. Nice pursuit on the tackle.
Well done by the Saints.
Absolutely.
That was linebacker Fraser Sopik that made the hit on that one.
Looks like Mark Delfatti was the ball carrier there and unable to get much. That'll bring up second and long.
It's a highlight reel play by Fraser Sopik. He's
yep.
His brothers all came to St. Andrews as well. Wonderful family, and he'll... He'll be talking about that play in the hallways for the rest of the week, I can tell you that.
He made a nice tackle, and we're seeing maybe why the Cary Blues don't run the ball a lot. They haven't had a lot of success with it, but back in shotgun for Calvin Vaughn, and this will be another throw. Vaughn will go
end zone
here. He's got A guy, that's a touchdown.
No flag on the play.
No, that's Matthew Crocker. That Crocker kid, he is making plays all day for the Cary Blues, and he makes another one there, hauling in the pass, and another great throw by Calvin Vaughn. That is a touchdown, and the Cary Blues have a chance to get them within a field goal.
Absolutely. That was a wonderfully thrown ball.
Sure was.
And the receiver, who is number one go-to receiver, obviously,
yes, has
just been making plays today.
Yeah, Matthew Crocker, I like his routes. You know, he's running them very precisely. He's separating himself from coverage, and he's a problem right now for the Varsity Blues. I'm sure the defensive coordinator, Courtney Shrimpton, who, of course, was the head coach years ago, might have to start talking to his defense about how to do a better job covering 82, Crocker.
They may have a discussion as they come off the field right now, because I'm sure that the Saints coaching staff are saying the exact same thing right now.
Yeah, we got to defend this guy
Defend this guy, because they're going to him, and he's been impressive, without a doubt.
Well, you know what, when you're a quarterback, it happens, right? You isolate a guy who you, in practice, is catching all the balls from you. He's running all the routes that you're asking, and he becomes your go-to guy. And you're sort of, you know, you're zoning in on him. I know you never want to, you know, give a defense an opportunity where they know where the ball is going, but you got to feel there's a comfort level right now between quarterback and receiver, and we're seeing that right now with Vaughn and with Crocker.
And you can't blame the quarterback either. I mean, he hasn't he may have dropped the ball. I can't remember one that he has, but he was just the quarterback's throwing a wonderful ball, and it's being caught. And you go to the guy that's going to make the plays, and that's exactly what they're doing.
All right, well, the Cary Blues will kick off after the touchdown, and the Saints, they fumble this one, but they do pick it up, and that's another fumble, and that's a problem. Now, it is recovered.
Like
it is recovered by St. Andrews, but they're going to have a very, very long field to go. Wow, two fumbles on that play.
This could have been worst-case scenario. The fact that the Saints actually recovered that ball is pretty impressive. But
if they don't recover that, then the Cary Blues have a very short field.
Absolutely.
Well, first down Saints, and it's going to be at their own 10. Do you think that's because of the wet ball?
You know what? It may have something to do with it, for sure. The Cary Blues were coming hard, though, and sometimes, you know, you're wanting to react, and you don't tuck the ball away properly, and so on, and all of a sudden you see these five guys coming right at you, and things happen, obviously, right?
You know what? The good news for the Saints, the last time they were pinned back, they got about a 90-yard run by Cole, so we'll see if they can get another one here, and, well, here we go. This
probably
one,
not a bad choice.
Yeah, this one, not so much, as he is, he's hit by a couple guys, and I think the Cary Blues knew what was coming there. They were playing the run. And you got to be a little conservative here if you're the Saints. You certainly don't want to turn the ball over at this point of the field. Worst case scenario, you kick and you play some defense.
Absolutely.
Right now.
And it's a decent run by Femi Cole. He just couldn't shake the one defender, and that's then he got double teamed. Not much to do in that situation.
No. And right now, Chris Merchant, we'll see. This is probably a situation where he will be throwing the ball. Second down, deep in his own end, as Merchant now will throw, looking for a guy. He's got no one, so Merchant scrambles. Now he's got someone, but the pass is slightly overthrown.
Then there's a flag on the
play
as well.
You know what? That was a hit on a defenseless receiver.
Yes,
and that will give the Saints a first down. The ball was overthrown, and you know what? We're seeing in football at all leagues that is something that is called, that it's to protect the player. When a receiver's in a vulnerable position and he's hit like that, you're going to get a flag every time.
That's a dangerous hit. That's a dangerous-looking play. It was close to that ball. It was a well-thrown ball. It was just over him a little bit. There could have been a hold on that, but you know what? You get away with that the odd time on the outside. But that was a late hit, and luckily he's all right.
There was a couple penalties because the referees now are talking with St. Mike. So they are calling two different things here, it looks like. We'll see how this works out. They might have to replay the down if the initial penalty was on St. Andrews.
Right.
Yeah, the first penalty was on St. Andrews. The second one was that late hit.
Late hit,
so that
yes.
These penalties probably offset, which will mean a replay of second down. Referees now are going to make it official,
yes.
But the first penalty, as mentioned, was on the Saints, and this will give the Saints the first down.
Yes,
they're not going to give them all the yardage you would have got if that initial penalty hadn't happened. But the
exactly.
two penalties, the personal foul on the late yep. hit on the receiver, will give the Saints the first down here.
Looks
little
like
little confusion still with the referees
yeah,
of both teams.
Anytime, still having
anytime,
some discussion.
Anytime penalties are on both teams and one is a harsher penalty than the other
right.
one, it'll create some confusion. The rain's starting to come down a little bit harder here. We'll see if this affects either offense. Both teams certainly want to throw the ball. We'll see if, as I mentioned earlier, Merchant, who played in Calgary, will be used to a wet ball. And we'll see how this affects the game, but I mean, we'll see another run and another penalty coming down.
Another penalty.
That'll be another hold on St. Andrews.
There it is.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know if it's going to affect the boys on the field, but the commentator is certainly going to get his jacket on because the rain is starting to pour down.
Yeah. Hold on the St. Andrews Saints, and here we go again. Another hold. I mean, they got to work on this, maybe Dave, because. This is the fifth or sixth holding penalty
yeah.
that's negated a big play for the Saints already in this game, and they've only played one quarter in 4 minutes.
And, you know, if these holds are happening in the first quarter, then you can almost suggest that it is homecoming. There's some,
yeah.
You know,
you
work out the kinks,
yeah.
it's fine, but we're now, you know, just into the second quarter. That should be long gone now, and there's nothing more frustrating for a coach than a great play, and it's called back on a hold.
Well, I know Len Gurr pretty well, and I can guarantee you he's not very happy with all the flags on the all the laundry on the field
Absolutely.
Early on in this one.
Well, he certainly had his hands on his sides, and that's the quintessential Len Gurr look when he's
right.
when he's frustrated.
Yes.
I've seen it before,
yeah.
and I suspect we'll see it again.
Well, I'm sure the Saints don't want to see it that often, but
no.
unfortunately with all the flags. Sloppy game so far. We've seen drop passes, we've seen holds, we've seen some late hits. So we've seen a lot of stuff that I'm sure both coaching staffs want to get out and get them corrected pretty quickly.
Absolutely. And if they didn't know what they were going to talk about at halftime, I think they now know what they can talk about.
Now here we go. This will be a first and long now for
Merchant's
the Saints. And
Merchant
will
the ball.
Take off again. I always worry when
yeah.
a quarterback takes off because of that, what just happened. I mean, you are vulnerable
yeah.
to a big hit, and he got hit by four guys.
Yeah.
Merchant, though, pretty tough guy.
No, he very much is. I'll tell you, he works out hard.
So
you could hear that hit up here.
Sure could.
And he's got to feel that one, without a doubt.
Well, whether he's sore or not, he will get back
Off
in the
go.
Huddle and call
yeah.
a play, and it's second down.
Yeah.
Second down for the Saints here, deep in their own territory. Couple penalties already on this drive. 10:35 to go, second quarter. Saints up 14-11 with the ball deep, second down. Merchant again to throw. Merchant throws deep. Looks to be defended very well, and it is.
It was.
Yeah, as a nice play by the DB, Mark Delfatti, with the coverage, and that ball. You know, we had a good vantage point. We're right at midfield. You could see the DB, Delfatti, was right
yeah.
there. That was going to be a remarkable catch if the receiver could somehow come down with that.
I think Daniel Cummings perhaps would have caught that if it bounced off the defensive back's helmet or something.
Right.
But at the same time, it
Delfatti defended it well.
Yeah, it was great. It was underthrown a little bit as well, so which might be a result of him having some pressure in the pocket,
yep.
too.
All right, so here we go. The Saints now having to punt deep in their own end. On third down and long, and this punt fielded at the 50. It is dropped, but picked up, and, a nice return, but
there's
there is a hole. That'll probably
flag,
be an
yep.
illegal block, and it'll probably
right.
come back.
Yep.
Again,
yep.
when you watch enough football, you generally know what
Absolutely.
The, even if you don't
Absolutely.
See it, you know
yeah.
what the flag
yeah.
is for.
Yeah. Nah, you're right. You
yeah.
sit down and watch football on a Sunday afternoon,
That's
and,
right.
and even the commentators say the same thing. Well, that'll likely be a hold.
Exactly.
That'll be coming back
that
for sure.
This will be coming
yeah,
back.
Yeah. They wait for the confirmation, but it's pretty clear.
Well, you know what? No one ever said this was going to be an easy homecoming
nope.
game for the Saints.
Absolutely
the Cary
not.
The Blues came to play.
And indeed, you know, for both teams, they've been sloppy at times. But when they're on, I'll tell you, it's been some great football. I ran into a parent of a grade 5 student here at the school, and I introduced myself, and he said, well, this is the first high school football game I've seen in 20 years or something like that, and yep. I thought you're going to enjoy yourself.
Oh, absolutely.
This is tremendous, tremendous football.
Well, great athletes. Great athletes, great coaching. These yep. kids, they, you know, barring some of the penalties, they certainly understand what they've got to do, and sometimes the run here by
That's
the Cary Blues
run.
Will be a first down run, and it is into Saints territory.
That's
a very
Duncan,
nice run.
Duncan Colson with the run. He shed a couple of tackles.
Yes,
nicely done.
Well, we haven't seen the Cary Blues run a lot.
No.
That is a first down run. My point earlier was basically that, you know, when I mean, playing high school football myself and playing at the CIS level, I think sometimes referees are, you know, they can do a better job not always throwing the flag on tic-tacky plays. We've seen a lot of that here. And as a coach, there's really not much you can do. You do coach your kids to play a certain way. And if you do see things called that are pretty borderline, really it's out of your control.
They're back in shotgun once again to pass. That's
another completion. Good numbers, obviously, completion-wise. Calvin Vaughn's got a pretty good quarterback rating
Absolutely.
Today.
Kayon Grant with the reception, but nice coverage by the Saints as well.
Yep, it'll be a second down, second and short.
I think what a lot of people, you know, forget is that the boys in the Cary Blues and the Saints here, they're students as well.
Yep.
They're off in the gym in the evenings. You know, they're working out during the summertime, and they've got to keep a certain standard of their academics up. It's impressive to see this high level of football, knowing that these guys are working hard on other things as well.
Well, exactly. They can't just focus on football. There's
That's
so
right.
many other things
That's
that
right.
They're responsible for. Second down and short. Again, we see
going
Vaughn
long.
In the shotgun, and Vaughn's got a guy deep, but this one's going to be
close.
Almost intercepted.
Almost intercepted
wow.
by Fraser Sopik.
Wow, Sopik. He had a beat on that ball, but unfortunately.
Oh, I'm sorry. That was Josh Carter.
That was number three,
apologies.
Not
number
two.
Yes.
Yeah, Josh Carter.
Josh Carter.
Ball was in his hands, but that's a tough play. You're adjusting
yeah.
to that ball.
Absolutely. And the field's a little wet, and he
absolutely.
Slipped coming back. But I'll tell you, that would have been a nice interception.
Well, as it turns out, it'll be third down, and I would expect a punt here from the Cary Blues. Certainly too long to go for a field goal from this point right now at the 43, and they are going to punt. So St. Andrews back in punt formation. Well, you know what? Good job by the Saints defense there. They did not give up many first downs. They got
You're
one
right.
on that not driving the run play, and they do get the ball back, but again,
deep
yeah,
in our
well,
field.
Well, let's see if they can
shake
do something.
And bake a little bit there.
They are going to have to take over from their own 15-yard line. So a long ways to go for the Saints. And right now the field position game being won by the Cary Blues.
I'll
this is two
you.
Straight possessions that the Saints have taken over deep in their own territory.
Absolutely. And I think the Saints have an uphill battle here. They've got the talent to get out of this hole, but we're still up 14-11, but they're deep in their own zone.
Well, of course, the play of the game, in my opinion, was the Femi Cole
oh,
run
absolutely.
On the first and 20 from their own, I believe, 20, which was a 90-yard touchdown run. We could use another one of those, couldn't we,
oh,
Dave?
Oh, I'll tell you what. You give him the ball and some magic happens. Of course, when Chris goes back in the shotgun, he can also hit any one of his receivers at any moment. So we'll see what they come up with here. Shotgun
Merchant,
again.
Merchant is in the shotgun. Merchant is going to throw. And Merchant's got a guy! And That's Merchant's got a first down! Into Cary Blues territory all the way down to the 40. Great game, great throw. Some amazing separation
that
there.
That was a beautiful toss. That's Zach Marcus. I'll tell you what, it was one-on-one downfield, and Marcus just beat his guy inside.
Marcus, one of the team captains.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well done. Well, I'll tell you, Jonathan Femi Cole is going to – he made a highlight reel play, and I would say that's got to be my second favorite of the day right there.
All right. Well, they will now have the ball first down at the Cary Blues 40-yard line. First down for the Saints. Saints up 14-11, 6:35 to go in the second quarter. Saints trying to add to their three-point lead. Again, Chris Merchant under center will – fake the handoff, play action, and this one will be complete.
Absolutely.
And another first down and more
stays in
for
bounds.
The Saints. Ryan Keyes, great play as he steps out of bounds and has the first down.
First down for Ryan Keyes. That was a really nice play. looked like short yardage to start, but man, he made something out of nothing. But he was wide open there in the flats, and he did a good job.
The play action worked, right?
Yes, absolutely.
I think the Cary Blues were expecting a run there.
Yeah.
And play action working and giving them a first down.
Nice fake to Jonathan Femi Cole, and a couple bit on it, and off we go. Well done.
So at the Cary Blues 25-yard line, Saints in business again, looking for their third touchdown of the first half.
This is a nice response by the St. Andrews squad, I'll tell you.
And we are going to get a run, and we are going to get another first down right in.
Femi Cole going in with a touchdown. No flags on the field. No flags. I think I need to check that now every single time.
No celebration, too. Yeah.
Nice five down low. There you go. Yep.
Well, that's a second touchdown now for Femi Cole, and that will give the Saints the 20-11 lead. And, wow. Just so elusive, man. Femi Cole gets the ball, sees daylight, he is gone.
He is an absolute powerhouse. And I'll tell you, you see him on walking down the halls on Monday, you congratulate him for his touchdowns, whichever one. And
yeah,
he'll
you got two to congratulate
yeah, exactly,
him on now,
and he'll just look at you and go, thanks.
Extra point, always, always a bit of a trouble issue today, and that one's blocked. So the Cary Blues do block the extra point. The Saints have had some issues with the kicking game today, and the Saints will have a 20-11 lead with 5:41 to go in the second quarter.
Solid series for the guys. Like I said, they responded very well to some sloppy play earlier on in the quarter. Just some nice stuff going on down there. And like I said earlier as well, when these guys are on, and both the Cary Blues and the Saints, when they're on their game, this is an excellent football game.
Well, you know, I think the good news for St. Andrews for homecoming for them is that you don't want to bring an opponent in that's going to be a team that you can really steamroll,
right,
because you really
right.
can't gauge how good you're going to be.
Absolutely.
And from what I've seen from the Cary Blues, they've come to play. So I think that St. Andrews will have a pretty good idea the things they have to work on playing a pretty quality opponent in their homecoming game.
And chatting with Jeff LaForge this morning, who helps out with the junior squad as well, I forgot to ask him about the quarterback. I wasn't, it'd be interesting to know if the Saints had the info on the Cary Blues quarterback, because I'll tell you, Calvin Vaughn has had a really solid day.
Sure has. A couple drops, and this game will be a little bit closer if not
without
for those drops, right? Well, the Cary Blues now will field the kickoff and will start from their own 23-yard line.
A big hit.
Special teams doing a better job for the Saints. The last couple kickoffs have been defended pretty well. And we're seeing, seeing both teams actually having to start pretty deep in their own territory mm-hmm. after some good special team play.
Coach Trimpton's going to like this field position a lot better than what he's seen in the last couple of plays.
Absolutely.
For sure.
Oh, the Cary Blues will start from their own 23, and I'll make a bold prediction. You can expect Calvin Vaughn to be throwing the ball a lot here.
I wonder if Calvin Vaughn is going to listen to this broadcast later, or watch it later, rather, and say, hey, I want my buddies to call me Gunslinger now. It's my new nickname. There it is.
Yeah, Calvin Vaughn has spent a lot of time in shotgun. He's not in shotgun on first down here, and they will actually run the ball, and they're going to run it for no gain.
No gain at all. That was Sopik again.
Well. Yep.
That was, and Sopik's quite happy with himself. Well, nicely done.
Yeah, it was Adrian Cole, the ball carrier for the Cary Blues. No gain on the play, brings up second down and long, and, well, now you could expect a pass on second down.
Well, I was with you 100% when you called it the first time, but
yeah.
I think it's almost a guarantee to see him in shotgun this
yeah.
time.
Yeah. Well, I didn't say first play. I said you
That's
expect
right. Yes,
second,
you're right.
You
you're right.
You expect to see a
yes.
lot of that, right?
Yes.
So, and he is in shotgun on second down and long. So, obviously, the Saints know what's coming here. It will be a pass, and we'll see if he finds his favorite target, Matthew Crocker. He does.
He does.
Matthew
he
Crocker,
does.
First down.
First
so
down.
I think we're getting a pretty good gauge
yep.
of this Cary
yep.
Blue offense. It
Absolutely.
Is the Calvin Vaughn to Matthew Crocker show. These two have been hooking up all day.
This is going to be big time conversation for the Saints at halftime, I'll tell you. Somehow
how
to get more.
82?
Yeah, absolutely. We've got to deal with 82 because we know number 12 is going to be able to get him the ball.
Yeah.
We know that for sure. That's a guarantee. So how are we going to deal with 82? I'll tell you. He's something else.
Well, you know what? If I had a fantasy team, I'd be drafting, I think, 82 in the second or third
yeah,
round.
Yeah, exactly. That's a great
idea.
He's the
guy you want to be starting every Saturday if there was a CISAA fantasy team.
Absolutely. Well, He certainly impressed me. He's got great hands, and he's running some serious routes.
And he's lining up wide, and this will be a run here for the Cary Blues. And again, no gain. Nice job of the Saints defense. Really hard to run on this defense.
Yeah.
And the Cary Blues having no success running the ball.
One or two series they've actually they ran the ball with decent success, but really nothing appreciable. It's been their air game that's been so impressive. Very impressive.
Second down here now. Again, second and long. 3 minute warning coming up. 3:15 to go in the second quarter. Saints lead the Cary Blues 20-11, and after a couple minutes of rain, it's stopped, which is great. So now here we are, pretty ideal conditions for football. Audible here called by the Cary Blues, and again, we will see
interception.
That's picked off. Daylight. That's a great
pick. That is Josh Carter. Fraser
Sopik.
Pardon me. Fraser Sopik.
Yeah, Sopik, who you had called out earlier on the play where the ball went through Josh Carter's hands. Sopik makes the play here.
Wonderful play. Great football play by Fraser Sopik, I'll tell you. He's smart out in that field, but and like I said earlier with his play, we are going to hear about that one on Monday for sure.
Well, that's a first down now for St. Andrews. And you know what? The first, I guess, big play by the defense causing a turnover. And that's exactly what I know the D.C. Courtney wanted to see.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So this, the Saints up by 9 with 2:46 to go will take over in St. Mike's territory.
Excellent field position now. Let's see if the Saints can capitalize on this.
Well, Chris Merchant back out at quarterback. Merchant has thrown the ball well. He's run the ball well. He's taken some hits. There really isn't much he can't do.
No, there really isn't, honestly. That's why he's got a D1 scholarship. I mean, not only is he a tremendous young man, but he's a hard worker, and he's got such talent.
Well, Merchant in shotgun. They are going to throw here on first down. Merchant
and they go
is going to go end zone, and Merchant! Oh, my goodness, he had a guy wide open.
Zach Marcus wide open and just off his fingertips.
Wow, Marcus, that ball goes off his hands. Wow, that's a tough play. That's a good ball by Merchant. There were two DBs there. And
double coverage.
He was behind the coverage. A ball that I'm sure he wants to catch. That's a ball that went off the fingertips, and Merchant threw a good ball.
That's a half step. Not even probably. Right on his fingertips, and Marcus will want that back without a doubt. Without a doubt.
Zach Marcus, a team captain, usually makes that play. Now, this is a hold. So, actually, the touchdown was not accounted.
Right.
Another hold on St. Andrews. Well, they are going to accept the penalty, which will make it a first and 20. You never know, right? You know, second and 10, first and 20. You can decline that on an incomplete pass, but they are going to make the Saints go back 10 yards and try to convert a first and 20. Another hold, and I don't know how many, but it's been quite a few holding penalties called against St. Andrews today.
I guess we should have started to count in the first quarter. I didn't think to do that, but
the holding count.
Wow, the holding count,
Now Merchant now in shotgun. We'll pass again here on first down. First and 20. Merchant's got a guy. Merchant's got a lot of that. First and 20. He's got a lot of that yards. He's got, you know, more than the penalty yards. That'll be about a second and three or four.
Yes.
Yeah, nice 16, 17-yard gain on first and 20.
And Zach Marcus pulling that in. He's an excellent receiver, and again, he'll want that one back.
You know what? Even if he caught it, it wouldn't have counted anyway,
right? That's right. So we just hit the reset button.
And
you know,
right.
It's a smart call by the Saints coaching staff, too. They're first and 20. Why not start it all over again? They've had great success. They've got such weapons out there. Why not?
All right. So here we go. It's second down and 3, and a pass again. And here's the first down.
First down, Zach Marcus once again with the reception.
Wow. I guess we're now seeing where Chris Merchant wants to throw the ball,
too. That's right.
He's seen the old 88 club.
Yes, exactly. And that's a nice block by Daniel Cummings, too, on the outside. Help Merchant or help Marcus actually get the first down.
Well, Marcus, two catches. So what was once a first and 20 is now a first and 10 as they are able to convert the first down. All right, so here we go. First down for the Saints as they are penetrating deep in Cary Blues territory. Just inside the 20-yard line now. Merchant in shotgun.
Back to
Merchant
pass.
Will throw again, and Merchant will buy time. He's got a guy, and he's got about, he's got a first down again.
First
there
down
you go.
To Ryan Keyes. Another nice toss. I'll tell you, that offensive line is giving Merchant
a lot of time to throw that ball. They really are. I mean, props to the offensive line. I know Coach Kerr was an offensive lineman during his days at Western.
Yes, he was.
And he's got a soft spot for the offensive line, and why shouldn't he? But I'll tell you, they're –
Well, the guys in the trenches, I mean, they're not guys we talk about a lot, but they are guys – they do the dirty work.
Oh, they certainly do. And that's a tough gig down there. They're up against some tough boys on the other side there.
Tough decision here for St. Andrews, because you want to score, but you don't want to give the Cary Blues
a
lot of time. One minute to go now in the second quarter. We'll see if they run the ball. They do.
They do to Femi Cole, who pounds his way
almost in the end. He is in the end. That's his third touchdown of the game.
Third touchdown of the game.
Wow.
That's just sheer power right there. That's all that is.
Jonathan Femi Cole is, he is dominating here on St. Andrews homecoming. His third touchdown of the first half. He had the 90-yard score early on. He would score in the last possession, and now here we go with under a minute to go. Femi Cole finds pay dirt, and the Saints have a 26-11 lead. Extra point pending. And again, the extra point has not been automatic today, but the extra point attempt will come.
I think. I have some faith in these guys this time round. You know,
I'm predicting they hit this one.
See Chris Merchant back to take the kick.
Another bobble. This will be the,
I don't know if I like this very much. And Zach Marcus scrambling on the outside.
Oh, Marcus
throwing it deep in the end zone.
Can he throw the ball? He can! And there's a flag
on the play. But he threw it to the quarterback, who was the guy kicking the ball. So...
Just like they drew up.
I can see Coach.
The penalty is on St. Andrews.
I can see Coach Shrimpton scratching his head over there, wondering what just happened now. But that was very interesting. That was fun to watch.
Well, the penalty is on St. Andrews, which will mean that the two-point conversion will not be good. They'll get another chance to kick the extra point.
Well, we can only hope we get a third opportunity, because that's really what we needed back in the first quarter.
That's right. Well, you know what, though? The Saints, a 26-11 lead, and after a second quarter that was tight. It was 14-11 when this quarter began. The Saints really did a nice job taking over the quarter and getting some separation from St. Mike's.
It responded really well. And, you know, for the people watching at home, this is not only is this great football, it's exciting on a variety of levels, not only with all the flags, but there's some unique plays going on out there.
Oh, you know, offensively, the Saints have really put on a clinic.
Yes, they have.
They really have. Yeah. You know, defensively, I think they got a little bit of work to do, but offensively, the kick is good. There we go.
Yeah,
we got an extra point, so 27-11 Saints. Offensively, this team is rolling. They're running the ball. They are obviously the passing game is working. They're getting plays from Chris Merchant with his feet, with his arm. Merchant has done a great job today when he's been under pressure, getting away from the pressure, eluding pressure, and giving his receivers more time to get open. And we've seen that really benefit the Saints' offense today.
Absolutely. And back to Femi Cole's last touchdown. I have to say, you know, the Cary Blues defended that fairly well. There was some good push off the offensive line for sure. But I'll tell you, that's just sheer power running through there. And this boy is a strong young man. If search him up on YouTube, there's some film out there of this guy doing some clean and jerks. Wow. It's absolutely impressive.
I'll be honest. I'm happy I'm not out there trying to defend him, because I think trying to hit Femi Cole, he might have a better chance trying to hit a bulldozer. this guy is making the Cary Blue defense have their issues today.
Absolutely, I'll tell you, he's and such a tremendous young man, but he is strong, and he just drives with that ball. It's amazing.
And as soon as he has any separation, he's gone. Like, good luck catching him.
He's got such good wheels for someone that size. He is
so
fast.
What's he run the 40, I wonder?
I wonder as well. It'll be faster than me, that's for sure.
Yeah.
I can guarantee that.
I won't even have to say the same thing, because that's a given for me. Anyway, here come the Cary Blues. Under a minute to go in the second quarter. And a good return here by the Cary Blues as they get the ball around midfield, and there was a horse collar that was not called that I'm sure some of the St. Mike's fans were not happy not to see a flag there, as the tackle was high, but no flag on the play.
No flag on the play, but
and
I
the
would
Cary
agree.
Blues, Cary Blues will take over at midfield.
Yeah, I would agree. 39 seconds to go in the second quarter.
Gee, with all the flags they've thrown, they actually missed one.
Well, it wasn't a hold after all,
no.
So you understand.
All right, so 39 seconds to go in the second quarter. The Cary Blues with the ball here. Down 27-11 as the Saints have taken control of the second quarter. What was a very evenly played first quarter and early in the second, but a couple back-to-back touchdown drives creating separation for St. Andrews, and that'll allow them, if they can get a stop here and not allow the Cary Blues to get into the end zone, give them a lot of momentum going into the second half today.
Absolutely. You know, thinking about this week of preparation, I'm sure the Saints knew of some of the weapons on the Cary Blues, particularly Calvin Vaughn and his go-to receiver, number 82, Matthew Crocker. But for sure, the Cary Blues have film on a couple of the Saints' premier athletes as well, and guy like Jonathan Femi Cole is putting on a clinic today.
Yeah, no, Femi Cole, I mean, that is just, what can you say about his first half performance? Extremely impressive. All right, so here we go, 39 seconds to go in the second quarter. One last possession for the Cary Blues. On their last possession, they turned it over. A great interception by, I think it was Frazier Sobek who made that pick on the last possession. So
strangely, I'm mixing Frazier Sobek up with Josh Carter.
Josh Carter.
Oh, they're wonderful friends, so they'll appreciate that for sure.
There you go. All right, so here we go. Cary Blues will run the ball on first down, and the Cary Blues close to a first down.
A solid run, for sure.
Nine-yard gain
challenges.
On the play.
A solid run.
No, they are staying a first down. They are moving the sticks, so a 10-yard gain and a first down. Never mind. I apologize.
No,
it is a second down. It looks like second and two, an 8-yard gain on the play.
31 seconds to go in the second quarter.
All right, so once again here we see Calvin Vaughn in shotgun. And that's picked
off
as well. That is
by number two, Frazier Sobek.
Wow, what an end to the half for Frazier Sobek. Two interceptions on back-to-back Cary Blue possessions.
Impressive. 13 seconds to go in the second quarter. What a tremendous play.
Wow, Frazier Sobek.
That
was incredible.
He's a gamer as well. I'll tell you what. He works hard and he loves the game of football. And you can just see.
Frazier Sobek's a linebacker too.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
And for a linebacker to make those two plays with his hands.
Well, I'll tell you, I coached him at the under 16 level, and as you might imagine, we've got a lot of really young players there that are learning the game. And he knew the game very well, and he was one of our leaders on the field. And he hit hard every time. And clean, but hard. And I'll tell you, he taught our younger guys who didn't know the game as well a tremendous amount.
Well, for Calvin Vaughn, who was so good throughout the first half, to have his last two throws be intercepted, that's got to be real demoralizing for him as the Saints now
will get another first down.
And look at this,
Femi Cole.
All the way down to the 10-yard line. Wow, with 3 seconds to go.
Wow.
The clock's going to stop here. That will give the Saints a chance to kick a field goal, make it 30-11, unless they try to be real aggressive and go end zone. But no, they're going to bring the field goal kicking team onto the field. 2 seconds to go. Saints
Absolutely.
Up 27-11. Yep. Now, the kicking game has not been easy for the Saints today. But
It's an interesting call.
Yeah, I think it's the only call.
It's the only call.
You bring the kicking team on, you try and extend the lead to 30-11.
No, I don't disagree with you at all. But it has been an adventure.
Yeah.
I was going to say earlier, Jonathan Femi Cole's giving me goosebumps up here. I don't know if it's the rain or it's his action on the field. I'll tell you, that's
He's
just
amazing.
Impressive.
His kid is just he has been absolutely money in the bank in the first half for the St. Andrews Saints.
Oh.
Boy, they got a real
Indeed.
Good one at running back with Femi Cole.
Now, I'll tell you what.
Now, the kick here is wide. That's going to give the Saints a single point, and it's going to make the halftime score 28-11. And the one area, I guess, that if you're Coach Gurr, you got to maybe take a look at is special teams in
Absolutely.
That kicking game. They've missed some extra points, field goals. But you know what? Overall, very good half for St. Andrews. They lead 28-11. And we're going to get a chance now to watch the marching band who is going to come onto the field, and we'll take a break. But great first half, Dave Stewart, the head coach of the junior team, joining me in the booth as the Saints lead St. Mike's, the Cary Blues, 28-11. Overall, Dave, your thoughts on the first half?
Well, listen, it's been an enjoyable first half to watch. You know, the Cary Blues have a lot of weapons for sure, and I have to say, it looked as though it was going
to
be a more a closer game than it was. But in the second quarter, there the Saints just picked it up, and the weapons that we have, very impressive, very impressive. Femi Cole for sure, but then you've got Zach Marcus making plays on the outside.
that kid is a gamer as well. And then, of course, I'd be remiss if I didn't mention Fraser Sopic. Yeah, two interceptions. That's impressive. I mean, that doesn't always happen, you know. So
you know what? Stick around. Dave Stewart and I will be back for the third quarter. But stick around. The halftime show coming up next. The Saints lead the Cary Blues 28-11 at the half. All right, welcome back. Third quarter just underway. The Saints lead the Cary Blues 28-11. And, boy, what a first half for the Saints offense. They were rolling late in this game. And, boy, third quarter, you got to figure the Saints will see a little more running because they've had a lot of success in the second quarter running that football.
I think you'll see Jonathan Femi-Cole grab that football a lot this this half. And I'll tell you, just an impressive half for the Saints.
Well, Femi-Cole had three touchdowns in the first half of this game. 28-11, the Saints, we're going to see them on defense to start here as the Cary Blues will begin the third quarter. And 28-11, you have to think the Cary Blues probably thought it would be closer after the second quarter based on how this game was going the first quarter and a half.
Yeah, we saw some impressive stuff from the Cary Blues without a doubt. And we'll see, they're going on the ground again. A nice run up the gut.
The Cary Blues didn't run the ball very well in the first half, but their first play in the third quarter is a run. And it is Liam Grippo, the ball carrier, gaining a first down. And you know what? That might have something to do with the fact that Calvin Vaughn threw two interceptions on his last two passes to Fraser Sopic in the second quarter.
Yeah, I'm not surprised that they're going to hit the ground game a little bit more now. I'd like to see Calvin Vaughn get back in the pocket again, get him comfortable, because I'll tell you, he was throwing a great ball earlier on.
Oh, it's Eric Cohen along with Dave Stewart. Dave Stewart, the head coach of the junior football team here at St. Andrews, also running the history department, so man, there's a lot here for St. Andrews, and there's a first down throw. So here we go. The St. Mike's Cary Blues getting into a bit of an offensive rhythm to start the third quarter. Calvin Vaughn finding his guy for a first down, and that's two first downs on back-to-back plays for the Cary Blues.
I think this is exactly what the Cary Blues needed to come out here firing, and they a couple of nice reception there, a couple of nice plays, and they're moving the ball on the 40 now.
All right, so here we go. Cary Blues, first down, down 28-11. So the score is certainly still in hand for the Cary Blues. If they could score here, they can make it a two-possession game. 13 minutes to go in quarter number three. And again, it is Calvin Vaughn.
Back
in
to pass.
Shotgun. He's got a guy open, and he's got a completion, and he's got a... they're saying down
like
at the
one.
Wow, looked like that was going to be a Calvin Vaughn touchdown throw. Instead, his receiver is down at the one-yard line, but a great catch by Liam Grippo.
Liam Grippo
and,
again. Yeah.
Grippo making the play down to the one, and the Cary Blues in business here. Whatever was said to them at the half at the halftime, they've listened, and they're moving the ball well in their first possession. It is starting to rain a little bit more here as well. Starting to come down a lot more, and we'll see how that affects the offense. But here we go, Cary Blues, first and goal from the St. Andrews
1 yard line.
And it will be Calvin handing it off, and no
looks
gain
like
on
a,
the play.
Looks like a big stop there on number 22, Duncan Colson, the ball carrier.
Nice job, and you know what? The Saints have played the run well all day,
yeah.
Dave Stewart. They've been up on that run, and really they've not been able to penetrate the Cary Blues running the ball. And again, that's about a one-yard loss in the play. So it becomes second and goal now from the Saints. Even though it's, offside by the St. Andrews Saints is going to give it first and goal.
First
again.
And goal.
Yeah.
Again, these penalties have been hurting the Saints. They're up in the score still, but wow, Coach Kerr can't like that at all.
No, would have been second down from the three. Instead, it's first and goal from the one. So this will give the Cary Blues another opportunity, and you cannot give, obviously, Calvin Vaughn extra chances. Vaughn now is going
to
throw.
Back to pass.
And Vaughn is going to throw it away. No one there. It's going to bring up second and goal. You know what? Probably three down territory here for the Cary Blues. You got to figure if they don't get it on second down, they're going on third.
I would say for sure. They're down in points. They need to put 7 points on the board to get back in this game. And they've had a great run here. For those watching at home, I have to tell you, it is raining quite dramatically.
It's raining hard. This is the hardest it's rained all day.
That's right. And it's impressive for these guys to keep going. I'm not sure you'll see them air it out too much
They don't need to right now on the 1 yard line, but it's wet out there right now.
Calvin Vaughn, I would expect a run here, and we're going to get a run here, and we are going to get a touchdown.
Touchdown.
Terry Blue touchdown on the ground.
That's number 22, Duncan Colson again.
He's had a good series. Duncan Colson, who plays DB as well, running back, both ways, getting it done there for the Cary Blues. And just like that, the lead cut to 28-17, extra point pending. Cary Blues a chance to get the score to within 10, 11:26 to go in the third quarter.
Be interesting to see how the Saints respond as well. Come out here and see if they can put some more points on the board. And this weather is certainly going to change the game plan a little bit, I would think.
Wow, it is.
It's really coming down right now.
We're getting close to torrential downpour territory here.
That's right. This is Scottish weather at this point, for sure.
Oh, boy. Well, both teams are struggling with the extra points, as the extra point is no good.
That ball will be slippery right now, without a doubt. Without a doubt.
Yeah, that's tough. It's in this weather to convert kicks. Don't expect to see a lot of long field goals, Dave, in the third or fourth quarter if the weather continues like this.
If it wasn't the game plan already, I think it is now to give the ball a wee bit more to Jonathan Femi-Cole and let him see what he can get out of it. But I'll tell you, this is sheer misery right now. Absolutely. If I wasn't with my new friend here, I think I'd be putting the headset down and walking away, because this is absolutely atrocious.
Well, Femi Cole had a first half for the ages. Three touchdowns.
Wow,
he had that long one, the 90-yarder on the first and 20 from his own 20. And we'll see it, because you're right. A steady dose of the run game is what you would expect in conditions like this.
Yes.
Well, it's going to be tough here to kick as well, and we'll see how the Cary Blues manage the kickoff as they kick off from their own 45. Cary Blues coming off that touchdown, down 11 here, a lot of time to go, third quarter. Cary Blues will kick off, and the Saints, you're right, will get their first possession, and we'll see the Saints offense for the first time in the third quarter, barring any sort of a turnover.
And here we go, Zach Marcus, number 88 with the ball.
Wow, look at this. Great
return.
Juking
up the middle. He's got one man to miss. Oh, and down at the
midfield. Yeah, great return by Marcus Heaton. Boy, he had a great first half, too.
He really did. Absolutely.
Team captain and one of the leaders on this team.
All-around solid kid. I'm saying that a lot, obviously, but I mean it.
Well, you know what? You know these kids,
and
you have an opportunity to, and I'm sure that you know, it means the world for them to be out here homecoming.
Yeah.
Doesn't really matter what the weather is. Just to be out here playing football in front of their friends, in front of their family, in front of a nice crowd here. It's a great atmosphere, and it's a great field again. And I know when they made this field, they took the weather into account that you'd have games like this.
Yep, absolutely they did.
All right, so here we go. Femi-Cole, the ball carrier. That's a gain of two in the play, two or three.
They keyed in on him right away.
Well, you know what?
Run.
And you can tell from how the Cary Blues reacted defensively, and look at them celebrate. Not often you see a defense celebrate that much on a play where the running back gains three, but you hold Femi-Cole to 3 yards, that's a victory
that's
for the
defense. You're doing something right at that point, for sure. We've seen him break free for some unbelievable runs today, so holding him to three is a big deal.
All right, so second down, and Chris Merchant now will be in the shotgun on a passing down. Merchant had himself quite the first half. And Merchant will go, and he's got a guy, and he's got a first down.
And that's Zach Marcus once again with the reception.
Well, we talked about having your go-to guy, and there's Merchant's go-to guy right there.
He's been tossing that ball out to number 88 an awful lot today, and 88's been bringing that ball home. So it's been great job by Zach Marcus. And like I said earlier in the telecast, he has some weapons. Chris Merchant has some weapons, not only himself, but he's got some weapons on the outside, and it's just fun to watch.
So a first down here for the St. Andrew Saints, up 28-17, 9:49 to go in the third quarter. Merchant in the shotgun, and Merchant is going to throw again.
Back to toss.
He's under pressure, though. He's under a lot of pressure. Merchant's going to be forced out of bounds.
Smart play by Chris.
Well, yeah, absolutely. Once you, of course, pass the line of scrimmage, you can't throw the ball. And there were three guys in pursuit of Merchant.
Yeah, yep. So best to step out of bounds, take a yard, and
avoid taking a hit.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah,
and that's the other thing. We saw Merchant take some hits in the first half. So you know what? Step out of bounds, avoid injury. Very smart.
Yes.
All right, so second and long here for the Saints.
Still a nice crowd down here as well. It's fanned out a little bit, but you've got the umbrellas out, and the St. Andrews faithful are still here.
Well, exactly. You know what? Rain never should scare away a football fan. This is a great football game.
Yes.
Homecoming for the Saints, and Merchant in the shotgun. Merchant's going to take off again, and Merchant is going to, wow, what a play
what a
by Merchant.
Block.
Look at that.
Merchant's
Chris
on
Merchant.
The run.
Unbelievable.
What a wonderful play.
This is an outstanding first down run by Chris Merchant. There were four or five carry blues in pursuit, and he made the miss, and he gains the first down with his feet, and he made a lot of plays with his feet in the first half as well.
Yes, he did. That was an outstanding block on the outside as well that freed up some space for Chris, but Chris made something happen out there, I'll tell you. He shed a couple blocks himself. That was a beautiful play. A broken play, no doubt. He
it
couldn't
was.
Find anyone downfield.
You know what? The Cary Blues doing a nice job defensively covering up guys, because a couple times already in this drive we've seen Merchant have to scramble because no one's been open.
Yes, yeah.
All right, so Merchant now first down. He's going to hand off here, and here we go again.
Femi Cole just
Out. You know what? And I think that obviously the Cary Blues know that's coming. Yep. Femi Cole is going to be a big part of this offense in the second quarter when you're up, right? You want the ball, you want the clock to keep ticking, you want to move the chains,
yep.
And you know, especially when the Cary Blues are able to score a touchdown on their last possession, you know, St. Andrews wanted to respond here and put some points on the board themselves.
They certainly do, they certainly do. And Femi Cole on that last run, he makes 5 yards where he probably should have only made one or two, if that. And he, you know, he just drives forward, puts his head down and grinds it out.
Got an injury here. P.J. Collins shaken up for the Cary Blues. So play will be whistled in as they will obviously attend to the injured Cary Blues player.
Having a hard time reading my program now. It got soaked and is basically disintegrating in my hand. So
well, it looks like P.J. Collins is okay. He's walking off, and obviously that's what you want. You don't want any injuries out here. P.J. Getting a nice ovation as he's able to jog off the field. All right, so here we go as the Saints drive will continue. Second down after the Femi Cole run, the 5-yard run. Cary Blues calling out some stuff on defense here, trying to defend a very high-octane Saints offense.
All right, back
to pass, and that is complete.
Caught Zach Marcus
Who
once
else?
Again.
His favorite Who target, else? Yeah.
And in double coverage as well, that's a great play.
That was a dangerous throw.
That was a very dangerous throw.
That was defended well.
That was right on the money, and Zach brought it home. Well done.
It's a first down. The chains will move, and a great catch by Zach on a high throw. You know what? I think that's really the only place that Chris Merchant could have put that ball.
Yeah.
All right, so the clock will continue to move. 7:11 to go in quarter number three. Saints up 28-17. Saints moving the ball on their first possession of the third quarter.
And as you say, the Saints really want to respond here. They want to get a touchdown to extend their lead.
Well, it's you know what, it's 11. The Cary Blues did score in their opening possession, so they're making this a game. And
that's right.
That's what you want. You know what, you want to see a very highly competitive game. Merchant to pass, he's got a guy, he's got another completion. Boy, both quarterbacks' completion percentages very high in this football game. This one looks like Austin Hassani able to bring it in. Second down now for the Saints.
Austin Hassani came up through the program as well. We coached him up there in the under 16 level. And I teach him in 20th century history. So there you go.
There you go.
Tremendous young man, I have to say.
Good student, good ball player.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, Saints here now. Second down. One more first down they can still get before bringing up first and goal. They don't have to score on this play without being able to still move the chains.
Femi Cole driving. Femi Cole.
Well, Femi Cole is met by three tacklers. The Cary Blues defending that very well. And Coach Gurr might have a decision to make here. Third down. I you know what? With this weather, I was going to say I'd go for it. It looks like they are going to bring in the field goal team, though.
And I'm not sure that's not a bad call by Coach Gurr. I mean, still relatively early in the game. We're in the third quarter, of course, but there's lots of game time left. And they move the ball really well. I think the only drawback might be the fact that we've struggled with the point after a little bit.
That's what I was going to say, is that with the kicking game struggling a little bit, and if you don't get the kick, you force the Cary Blues to go 100 yards. I would have probably gone for this, but you know what? Hey, they're going to go for three, and they're going to try to go up 31-17, go up by two touchdowns.
Right.
Watch the fake here. Maybe.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Watch the fake field goal. You never know. Maybe we'll see if the Saints have something up their sleeves.
The broken play from the second quarter, maybe they'll try to replicate that. Where,
yeah, that worked. They,
where
had,
they bobble
they
the
got
bombs.
It, but they had a flag on the
Zach
play,
Markets
right?
takes the ball and throws it deep to the corner
That's
to
right.
On the quarterback.
This is the traditional kick, and the kick is
looks like
good.
The kick is good.
All right, so you know what? Coach Gurr makes the right call. Puts the Saints up by 2 touchdowns. 31-17 is the score. And you know what? I think they probably thought about it, right? You know, it's third down. It's short yardage.
Yeah.
They don't need a touchdown to get a first down there, but – you get a chance to put points on the board. You get a chance to go by 2 touchdowns. You make the decision, and you know that's why you gotta love the game of football,
Absolutely.
Right? Coaches will always coach differently. And listen, I know Len very well. Very, very smart football coach. He actually comes on my radio show every Friday at 12:30 to talk about the Saints. And I always introduce him one of the brightest young football minds in Canada. he knows the game so well.
Yeah, and he'll love that, and he is. He really is, and he studies the game, and he lives it. He loves it. I'll tell you.
So there you go. Coach Gurr, right decision, kicking the field goal. 31-17, Saints lead the Cary Blues. 5:29 to go in the third quarter. 2-touchdown lead, and we'll see if the Saints defense can play a little better than what they did in the first Cary Blue possession of this quarter, because the Cary Blues did march on that drive, and certainly we've seen them have a lot of success throwing the ball in this game.
Nice kick as well. Cary Blues bring the ball.
A good return here. 40. Wow, look at this return.
Now one man.
The Cary Blues are going to be in business
Excellent
here. They're going to take over at the Saints 45-yard line. Yeah, great return. Cary Blues kick return team again. They've had some success today.
It's great to see that they're driving the field just insofar as we want to see this competitive game, and they're not going away.
No, Calvin Vaughn, he's a gamer. He's going to come out here, and he's going to continue to throw the ball in these conditions. The rain's still coming down, not as hard as it was when this quarter began, but we've seen Calvin Vaughn be very comfortable, and of course his go-to guy, Matthew Crocker, in the first half. You know that 82 is going to be out there looking to make some more plays here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I'd be shocked if they didn't try to hook up at least once or twice.
They got Crocker lined up there far right and talking a lot here on offense, trying to figure out what they're doing here. Referees having some words now with the Cary Blue sideline as they have a late substitution. But St. Mike's down 31-17, 5 minutes to go in the third quarter, and well, you know what, they score here. We're gonna be in store for quite the finish, maybe.
I tell you, the fourth quarter is gonna be interesting.
All right, so Calvin Vaughn, not in shotgun. They are gonna run the ball on first down, and no gain again on first down. They've not had a lot of success running
the ball.
Stuffed
them right up the middle there, and Fraser Sopik once again was in on that tackle.
That guy, there's your defensive player of the game right now. Two interceptions and a bunch of big tackles.
He's really impressed me, to say the least. And Coach Gurr speaks very highly of Fraser and on a variety of levels, but certainly his football acumen is excellent.
He's got that high football IQ.
Oh, he does. He does. He absolutely does.
All right, so here we go. Second down and long for the Cary Blues. 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. Down by 2 scores. Very competitive ball game so far. Calvin Vaughn continues to play at a high level despite the 2 interceptions. They are going to run the ball, and you know what? Wow, that's that was a bold call by the Cary Blues. The referee does blow the whistle, and this gets a little bit of forward progress. It's going to call up a third and short
for
the Cary Blues, and we'll see if they go for this. I expect they will.
Yeah, I would agree with that call. It looks like it's going to be – they may even bring the chains out. No, maybe not.
That's looks like it's going to be about third and 1.5 for the Cary Blues, and they are going to go for this. Yeah, I know you see Calvin Vaughn talking to the coaches there about what to call here. Third, a huge third down. Might be the biggest third down the Cary Blues have faced today.
Yeah, this is a big stop for the Saints here. They need to stop them right now.
All right, so here we
go. Could be a big momentum shifter for sure.
Calvin Vaughn lining up under center is going to hand it off. And wow.
Looks like he got it.
Yeah, he's got the first down by about 0.5 yard, it looks like. Yeah. And they're saying move the sticks.
That was a decent job by the Saints, for sure. But he was able to get the first down.
That's three straight runs there to get to move the chains for the Cary Blues. Something we didn't see a lot in the first half. They didn't run the ball a lot. They started with Calvin Vaughn in shotgun for most of that first quarter. Now we're seeing what the Cary Blue running game can do.
Well, it's interesting, too, that the weather must have an impact
on
the decisions that they're making down on the field. It's still raining here fairly significantly, and so he's just under the center and back to pass. However,
this is what that. There you go. What a play!
Beautiful play there by that's number three, Josh Carter.
Yeah, Josh Carter.
That's a beautiful play.
He did. He stepped in front of the receiver, knocked the ball down.
That's great anticipation.
You know what? And he did so without making any contact, so no flags. Hey. Knock on wood, we haven't seen flags in the third quarter.
Listen, I was just going to mention that. I'll tell you, maybe the refs had a little chat, decided to put those away.
Kinda well, like you know what? Let the kids play. Both teams are
absolutely
playing. Both teams are playing hard. You know, if it's like slight incidental contact, you don't need a flag. Come on, let them play. Anyway, second down and long now for Calvin Vaughn, and the Cary Blues offense. Calvin Vaughn in shotgun.
Back to pass as well.
And that's going to be tipped in. Oh, you know what?
Yeah.
There's pass interference right there. They are going to call that on Frazier Sopik, who had the two picks. They're going to call pass interference on the Saints on this play.
Yeah.
That's going to set up the Cary Blues with a first down. Yep, there's the call.
Yeah, there's the call.
Well, I guess I spoke a little too early about no flags, but I think, you know what, you look at the St. Mike's, you look at the St. Andrews sidelines, I don't think that too many people are questioning that call. They're sort of accepting that Sopik might have got there a bit early.
Yeah, and if they did question the call, I can guarantee you we would hear them up here.
Yeah, exactly.
You've known Len for a few years, and my good friend's quite vocal at times,
he
that's for sure.
Be. He can be. All right, so here we go. First down for the Cary Blues. At the Saints 21, they're going to run on first down, and they've got themselves a nice first
run.
Down, and they've got themselves a touchdown.
Touchdown,
Cary Blues.
And that was number 22, Duncan Colson, with the touchdown. That's a nice run.
Now, Duncan Colson's had himself a good quarter. He plays DB on this team as well, but he is running the ball. He's running well. He's finding holes, and you know what? He's just made this a 7-point. Well, barring the extra point, he's
That's
made
right.
this a one possession game.
Saints are going to have to come out and respond once again. This is an excellent football game. They're making this very interesting for the Saints.
Two possessions for St. Mike's, two touchdowns in the third quarter.
That's excellent. They really they hit the reset button there at halftime, I'll tell you.
Well, they didn't finish the second quarter very well. They had the two interceptions, and obviously They did some nice adjustments at the half, and once again, we're seeing a very successful Calvin Vaughn. And now for the first time in the game, he's getting a lot of support from his running game.
Right, which is exactly what they need right now. The rain's perhaps holding off a little bit right now, but he's not able to throw the ball quite the way he did in the first half.
So with 1:45 to go in the third quarter, Saints see their lead cut to 7. St. Andrews 31. St. Mike's 24. Good ball game. 1:45 to go. This one could be a very exciting finish.
Excellent,
Dave.
Excellent ball game. I mean, they're key. The Cary Blues are keying in on Femi Cole a little bit. He's not able to run quite the way he did before, and Zach Marcus is continuing to bring the ball down, which is excellent. So I can see the Saints coming out here and responding in a big way, however.
Now the Saints are going to get the ball as St. Mike's will kick off after their second touchdown of the third quarter. High scoring game, already 55 points in the third quarter. No lack of big plays. Both quarterbacks have played extremely well. We've talked a lot about what we've seen out of Calvin Vaughn and how he's been a nice job keeping the Cary Blues in this game here. Tough environment on the road, never easy to win at St. Andrews, especially on homecoming. So good job by St. Mike's making this a game, and we'll see how Chris Merchant and this the Saints offense responds as they'll get the ball here. Kickoff and a very short kickoff, but it's fumbled.
Fumbled by Zach Marcus.
Marcus had himself quite the game, but you know what? He recovers well after dropping that ball, picks it up, and the Saints will take over at their own 35-yard line.
One of the things I like to see, Marcus gets taken down there, and one of the St. Mike's players helps him up. That's good
sportsmanship.
Brotherhood, good sportsmanship, and And there's a lot of respect that both schools have for one another, and that's at both the junior and the senior level.
Well,
and
you know
I do like to see that.
There's been a lot of flags, but I haven't seen a lot of dirty play.
No,
right?
No,
it's been a very clean
not.
Game on both sides.
I would agree.
All right, so let's see what Chris Merchant can do as he takes over at his own 35. The rain starting to subside a little bit, but still a very wet field. And play action on first down Merchant. And Merchant again will take off.
Ball.
Merchant's got 5 yards. Merchant's got almost 10 yards.
Almost 10 yards
and,
on that one.
That'll bring up a second and short.
That's some great coverage by the backs there for the Cary Blues. But I was going to mention, the rain seems to be subsiding, but we seem to be getting some wind now, which is always very interesting in
that'll
football.
That'll affect the passing game,
exactly.
Will it not, right? Chris Merchant and Calvin Vaughn will have to deal with some inclement conditions.
Oh, will they ever? I'll tell you, just as we are. It's nice to be wet and having the wind just chill you to the bone.
Well, you know what? Great job by our camera crew today bringing this game to you guys as well. Making sure if you could not be here at St. Andrews for homecoming, you are enjoying the broadcast and you are enjoying a very well-played football game. The Saints up by 7 late in the third quarter, under 30 seconds to go right now. As the Saints are going to call timeout. It's the big down here. Second and short. You know, Coach Kerr wants to make sure that they got the right call. They're going to be able to move the sticks, and you'd obviously expect them to run the ball here on second down and short. You don't want to risk an incomplete pass having to pass.
And there's potential that they saw something as well that they didn't like with the Cary Blues defense, so they made a choice to call timeout and get it right.
All right, so 30 seconds to go in quarter number 3. Timeout by the Saints. Second down, big down for them as they look to move the chains. And I think we're going to be, in store for a really good finish of this football game, which I'm excited about. I know, obviously, it's homecoming. The Saints wouldn't have minded a blowout. But the Cary Blues had other ideas.
That's right.
They've come to play. And we're going to have a very, very good fourth quarter here as the Saints look for first down yardage on second and short. 30 seconds to go in quarter number 2.
And here's Chris Merchant.
In shotgun, surprisingly, and he's going to throw. And he's, almost picked off. The Cary Blues making a play there. That was, Eric Matu, the DB, who almost made the play. Third and short.
Just hesitating there. Third and 1. We got 25 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Well, I thought that would be a running play, obviously, second and short. But you know what? I guess the way St. Andrews was thinking, they were expecting a run.
Yes,
so try and catch them off guard. All right, so here we go. So third down, QB sneak maybe here.
You let Merchant
hold on to the ball and gain the yard himself. It will be a QB sneak, and it is a first down.
Looks like it's a first down, yep.
That's so tough to defend in Canadian football when you've got to line up a yard off
you've
the ball.
You've got to line up a yard off, and they've obviously got the advantage, and I'll tell you, it is difficult.
Yeah.
And well, you don't see them stopped very often.
No. And you know what? You see it in the CFL where you have, third down and 1, and you have a specialized quarterback who's obviously it's an art, right? QB sneak, that QB keeper. We've seen enough from Merchant today to know that he can run the ball very well. He's very athletic. So on a play like that, really the Cary Blues defense, what are you going to do?
He's a go-to guy. And it's nice to have a guy like Femi Cole in the backfield as well. But again, third and a yard, give it to your quarterback who's one of the top athletes on the team.
Absolutely.
It's almost a guarantee.
All right. So you know what? Fourth quarter underway. Saints up 31-24. They change directions as the Saints now will take over at their own 48 on first down. Merchant will play action, and that pass is, Merchant was hit as he threw it. Merchant looks like he's in some discomfort. That is not good at all. Merchant was hit hard on that play. He does get right
he
up.
Gets
he's a
up.
Tough guy, but he was hit.
He was hit hard, yep.
He's feeling it. There's a flag.
Late flag on that.
It looks like some sort of an unsportsmanlike flag penalty called here. Obviously, you know what? Maybe something was said.
I would think so. It looks as though it was
going to be on the Saints. That's going to be on the Saints. Well, this, I don't know, this
gets more interesting, doesn't it?
Sure does.
If you're watching this game at home, I wouldn't, maybe go get yourself some popcorn, but that's it. Sit down and enjoy this fourth quarter because it's going to be exciting.
Well, you know what? You got to wonder how Chris Merchant is doing after that play. He did get up slow. He's favoring something.
He certainly is.
Second and 20. Merchant's going to have to throw here.
And the last couple of times, I'll tell you, he's been under significant pressure, and the ball hasn't been quite to the same capacity as earlier in the game.
That's St. Mike's sidelines, very lively. They're feeling that they got a ball game here. That's a pass, that's a complete, but that's very short of a first down. All right, so that's going to bring on the punt team for St. Mike's for St. Andrews on third down.
Nice reception again by St. Andrews number 88 there, Zach Marcus, but well short of the first down.
Well, I guess that's a field possession situation where you're trying to get something back there before so you can kick from midfield. You're going to force the Cary Blues to go from as deep as possible.
Right.
The second half, you got to be really impressed with what the Cary Blues have done. They've mounted a nice comeback. They've played well defensively.
This is not good at all for the Saints.
It's going to work out.
The quarterback gets outside for a first down.
What a play
call. That was impressive.
That is a gutsy call.
Wow.
That was a design play. That is a gutsy call. Chris, third down at midfield.
Chris Merchant makes it outside. He had one defender to beat, and he beat him outside. That's just sheer athleticism. That was impressive. That was very impressive.
I'm going to have to ask Len Gurr after the game if that was a design call or not, because, man, that was...
Well, that's a good question, because it looks to us up here that perhaps it was, and yet it could have very well have been a broken play, and he made something quite dramatic out of nothing.
As soon as I saw it, I thought, oh, boy, you know, that was maybe a bad snap.
But he took off.
If he's tackled, obviously, the Cary Blues would take over at midfield.
Right.
All right, so we got a timeout now on the field. The Cary Blues are going to be forced to play some more defense. They probably thought they were getting the ball back, but a real gutsy call by St. Andrews. And boy, what can Chris Merchant not do?
Well, that was just impressive, and I'd like to think it was a call, although I'm not sure. That could have very well have been a broken play.
Well,
but
you're
if
a
it,
head coach yourself. Well, what did it look like to you?
I think it was a broken play, frankly. Okay. Yeah, right. I think it was a broken play. But knowing Len Gurr the way I do, there's a good chance my football acumen doesn't run anywhere near as deeply as his does, and I wouldn't be surprised if that was a play call because he's a gamer himself, and they needed that first down. And he put the ball in the hands of the guy who could get the first down for you. So
it'll be my first question to him.
Absolutely.
Was that a design play call on third and seven from midfield, up by seven with 13 minutes to go? But a real gutsy call. And hey, you know what? St. Andrews gets to hold on to the ball, and they got a chance to go up by two scores. And that was huge for the Saints. Here we go. Chris Merchant and the offense stays on the field. First down for the Saints.
Shotgun formation, back to pass.
That ball was picked off. It went off the hands of the intended receiver, and that is picked off. That ball was intended for Ryan Keyes.
We've got all kinds of activity in midfield. You've got helmet off. Femi Cole's got his helmet off, and there's lots of pushing. It's over now, of course, but flags everywhere.
Yeah, I was looking downfield that play. I saw the pass intended for Keyes, tipped and intercepted by the Cary Blues, and I missed what happened around midfield, but certainly there were some...
They're going to have to sort this one out.
I was talking about how clean this game has been, and it's got a little chippy in the
last
couple
minutes.
Well,
I'll tell you, it got intense. Something happened between one of the defenders and Femi Cole and maybe even Merchant, and... tell you, it got you and I were looking downfield at the interception, and there was something going on.
The referees now having to huddle amongst themselves to figure out. Now, they are talking with the Cary Blues, and they're going to give us what this penalty call is.
Right.
We're all sort of waiting in limbo, wondering what exactly was called here.
And there could be several as well. There were two flags that were flown.
Yeah, there were a couple
flown.
Penalties on that play.
Yeah.
Now, any sort of pass interference won't be called because it was a tip ball.
Right,
so that will negate that.
Yes. This has been quite a significant momentum shifter. It's 13 minutes to go in the fourth quarter, and the Cary Blues are fired up.
Well, we got to figure out what exactly the referees are discussing. Both teams are having to wait, and you know what? There's obviously something substantial that's been called because
yes.
We got about a 3 or 4 minute discussion by the three referees.
Yes.
It looks like the Cary Blues offense will come onto the field. We do know that. They trail by 7, 31-24, 13 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
This is going to be a true test for the St. Andrews defense when the play does resume. But they are the refs in the lengthy conversation. They're going to have to be discussing this with both coaches, well, I would assume.
As soon as we know what's been called, we'll let you know. And there are, looks like there's penalties on
both sides.
Yeah. All right, so Cary Blues, it's going to be first down, Cary Blues. The penalty happened after the interception. Yeah.
And yeah, Cary Blues ball.
Yeah, well, the Cary Blues are going to take over. It's going to be around midfield. First down for St. Mike's.
Yes.
St. Mike's down 31-24. And, again, we were sort of focused on the interception and the tip ball, and we didn't really see what happened around midfield where something substantial has happened, because not only do the Cary Blues get the ball, but they got a lot of yards and penalty yards here as well.
It looked as though there could have been, what, three objectionable conducts on that? Would that make sense?
There could have been 45 penalty yards on that play.
They could have, it's significant. They covered the ball somewhere around maybe the 26-yard line,
yeah.
I'm guessing. And we're sitting now at the Saints, 40-yard line?
Yep.
41-yard line? That's significant.
Well, we got a football game. The Cary Blues in business here in Saints territory. Down by just 7, and again, quarterback Calvin Vaughn's going to come onto the field with an opportunity. Len Gurr now is going to need a discussion with these referees because he sees the amount of penalty yards that they were called, and he's going to need an explanation
yeah.
as to what exactly was called here. Len does not look happy.
No.
He is not impressed by this call. Yeah, he's pretty animated there with the referee, but a long delay here as the referees really had to first figure out what the calls were. How they were affected after the change of possession, how many yards the Cary Blues would get, and very, very
right.
Crucial call here, which
right.
Has really benefited St. Mike's, and it's put them in business, a chance to tie the football game.
Right, and Len was very animated, and clearly he knows something that was going on in the scuffle at midfield that maybe the refs didn't see, or at least our perception of what happened, but I always like the way Len handles his relationships with the referees and so on. It's very respectful, and
yep.
You know what? It that speaks volumes about him, and it also resonates with the boys. I mean, he doesn't stand for any sort of that behavior on the field by our athletes, and you know, he doesn't do it himself. So,
well, I think when Coach Gurr looks at the film, there'll be a few flags that he'll probably want to discuss yeah. with some players.
Yes, he will. Yes, yes.
Anyway, long delay here as the referees continue to, figure out exactly where the ball is going to be. We do know it is St. Mike's ball. It looks to be around the 41-yard line.
And a significant gain off that interception.
Well, here we go.
First down, St. Mike's. Looks like we're about ready to resume.
All right, so.
And here we go.
Yeah, first down. The St. Mike's fans are really getting into it here as they know that they have an opportunity to tie this football game. And here we go as Calvin Vaughn will
throws
pitch
it outside.
It. Yep. And a good run. Adrian Cole on the carry.
Looks like a pickup of maybe 2 or 3 yards on that.
Yeah, you know what? We haven't seen a lot of that from – I haven't seen a lot of pitch plays, and Adrian Cole has the ability to obviously get to the outside and make something big out of that. So.
Well, interesting. That's just a gain of 1. That took a long time for 1 yard,
sure,
but it looked like it was maybe 2 to 3 yards, but my mistake.
Well, Calvin Vaughn now probably in passing down here. He's in shotgun. 2nd and 9 for the Cary Blues at the Saints 40.
Bad
Not
snap.
Not a great snap, no. But
and
the ball is dropped.
Incomplete
yeah,
pass.
So that's, you know what? Nice job of the Saints defense,
yep.
a quick 2 and out
yeah,
after
the
turnover.
Yeah, they needed to come out here fired up, but, you know, keep themselves in, you know, with focus, and they did just that, and not a great deal of damage done here, but I'll tell you, that was an interesting few plays there with the interception, then the must have been three objectionables. Yeah. Must have been.
Well, you know what the Cary Blues are thinking here? Field possession.
Yes.
You got to pin back St. Andrews and make them go a long ways.
Yes, yes.
And that is certainly what they're going to try and do here. That's a terrible
snap. Oh, that's a terrible snap.
Over the head
of the kicker.
Oh, boy.
In pursuit is number 24.
There you go. The Saints are in business. They're going to take over at the Cary Blues 35-yard line. You know what? The weather, the wind, it all factors in. And just like that, the Saints have the ball at the Cary Blues 35.
Well, Eric talks about field position literally 3 seconds ago, and now the Saints are deep in the Cary Blues territory.
Oh, my
fantastic
goodness.
Field position, but that it looked like the wind caught that ball and scaled it right over the kicker's head.
Wow,
unbelievable.
What a turn of events.
Wow. This is some serious excitement.
It is.
And I'm freezing. I just want everyone to know that. Well, don't feel sorry for me. I'm loving myself
exactly.
Right now, but it's a cold one. I can't believe those players are out there. They're doing a great job.
Well, here we go. It's the workhorse. With the carry, and it's about a 5-yard gain for Femi Cole.
That's a good run. I'll tell you, you get 5 yards from your back every single time you run the ball, and you're gonna be in business.
Well, you know what, Dave? I appreciate you holding up the umbrella.
I got this umbrella here.
While I focus on the action.
I don't think the people at home can appreciate just how much my umbrella is moving. Sometime we'll sit down and we'll talk about it, but I'll tell you, I've got two hands on
Dave
this umbrella
Stewart
right now.
Calling all the action for you, and you know what? We're doing the best we can
absolutely.
In the conditions.
Talk to our agents. We're up for this anytime.
Absolutely. Here we go. The Saints second down and 5. Chris Merchant will
back
run.
Back to pass.
And Chris Merchant will take off. And Chris Merchant, oh, boy.
Wide open. That, Zach now, Marcus off the fingertips.
Now, that, you know what? I thought Merchant was beyond the line
I thought
of scrimmage.
He was too, actually,
yeah,
yes.
But no flag on
yep.
the play.
That was a great play. Zach Marcus wide open, deep in Cary Blues territory. So now we're third and long.
Well, you know what? And we've seen the issues with the kicking, and we've seen the weather. And you know what? I don't know if this field goal is makeable.
No, this would be tough, I would think. There aren't too many high school kickers that can make it in that distance, and we've seen how St. Andrews has struggled a little bit in that category today. So
really, you have to go for this, right? You're not going to punt, you're not going to kick. So you know what? You go for third and 5. You take your chance. And with Chris Merchant, who's been able to make big plays on
absolutely.
Third down.
Yes, he has.
Oh, they're going to run
give
the ball.
Give it to the workhorse.
And they got a first down.
They got a first
look
down with Femi Cole's breaking tackles down inside the 10-yard line.
My goodness.
What?
Femi Cole is a beast. Wow. Jonathan Femi Cole on third down does what he's been doing all game, and that is moving chains and scoring touchdowns. He's got 3 touchdowns in this game. He just got a crucial first down for the Saints. And with under 10 minutes to go, the Saints now in the red zone. They are at the St. Mike's 9-yard line with a chance to extend the lead to 2 touchdowns.
And again, on behalf of Coach Gurr, I got to give the props to the offensive line on that one. Femi Cole had a massive hole to run through, and that offensive line did a tremendous job.
Well, Femi Cole has been unbelievable.
Back
and now
to pass.
Another pass, and
he's dancing. He's dancing. There he is.
Chris Merchant again making a play with his legs, and he's got a touchdown.
Number 8, Ryan Keyes for the touchdown.
Chris Merchant made that happen, avoiding the pressure. And, boy, I mean, what can you say? Chris Merchant, whenever there is a Cary Blue defender in pursuit, he uses his legs. He escapes the pressure. He finds the open man. He does it again. The Saints take a 37-24 lead.
It's just impressive. It's absolutely impressive. I can't even tell you, watching this game up here, Chris Merchant is making things happen. And that was he was in hot pursuit. The St. Mike's defender was right on him, wheels outside, perfect pass to Keyes. What a great play.
Well, you know, about 2 hours away from here in Buffalo, Buffalo fans might have a very special quarterback coming to them down the road.
Yes, indeed.
Because Chris Merchant is the real deal. And the Buffalo Bulls, who were, you know, they were in Toronto a couple years ago for the International Bowl. I had a chance to see them. They had a really good year a couple years ago. They've had some lean years since, but, man, they got a pretty good one here in Chris Merchant, who continues to put on the clinic homecoming at St. Andrews.
I'll tell you, if there are any doubters out there, they're certainly been silenced by Chris Merchant's play today. This has been unbelievable.
Could there possibly be any doubters? Who would doubt Chris
Listen,
Merchant?
I certainly wouldn't. I'm not one of those guys, that's for right. sure. But Buffalo certainly does have a top-tier quarterback. And I think anyone who watches Canadian football or appreciates Canadian football, it's rare for a young Canadian quarterback to get any kind of scholarship in the United States.
It is. You don't see it very often. Generally, you know, there you see a lot in the CFL, but even a lot of, like, you know, Brad Sinopoli was so good in the CIS. You see him playing receiver now for the Calgary Stampeders. A lot of times these quarterbacks are forced to play other positions, and, you know, Merchant is showing that he can play his own position pretty well.
Yes, he can. Yes, he can.
Now the Saints go up by 2 touchdowns, and, you know, a couple key third down conversions. Obviously, the big play there was the third down by St. Mike's on the punt that the bad snap, and the snap went over the player's head and put the Saints in business. And here we go.
That's a deep punt too.
Yeah, you know what? That's going to get to the end zone. It's going to force.
That's deep. That's a deep
Kerry
ball.
Blues, and I think they were thinking maybe it could have been a legal kickoff and go out of bounds, but it stays in bounds. And look
nice
at this return.
Back.
Great return by the Kerry Blues all the way out to midfield. Great job.
He switched directions there and made something happen. I mean, he was deep. He got that ball on the 1 yard line, almost in the end zone. Made it all the way out to the 56.
Yeah, that's Ray Martinez, I believe, who picked that ball up and went 50 yards after it looked like he had very little. Great play by Ray Martinez,
midfield.
Who will give the Kerry Blues good field position. Down by 14 with 9 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
Defense has to have another good series here. They did a great job last time, great coverage, so they need to be on their game again.
All right, so here we go. First down for the Kerry Blues. Offensively, they've moved the ball well throughout this game.
And Calvin Vaughn, number 12, the quarterback, back in the shotgun once again. It's his wheelhouse, and he's going back to pass.
Well, down by 14, you got to throw a lot.
Yeah,
he had
right.
a guy. He
you're
had
right.
a guy there, and unfortunately, he overthrew him by a yard or two.
Of course, the conditions out here have worsened. I mean, it's not perhaps raining as hard as it was earlier, but the wind really has picked up, which makes it really difficult, even for a solid quarterback like Calvin, to throw the great ball.
You know what we haven't seen a lot in the second half? Matthew Crocker.
Yes.
I talked about that in the
yes.
first half. Matthew Crocker really made a lot of big plays against the Saints defense, and he's been quiet in the second half. He hasn't been targeted by his quarterback nearly as much in the second half.
Again, quarterbacks always have tendencies, and certainly when they have a receiver that they're comfortable with.
There's Crocker right in front of us here lining up wide right. We'll see if they looked. I'm saying they looked to 82 here.
That's
we'll
possible.
See, we'll see if I'm right. Yeah, they're going out that way, but the pass is incomplete. That one was intended for number 91, Rayshon Smith, and a little bit over Smith. And
just off the fingertips.
Yep.
Not a bad pass, just off the fingertips. He had to jump for that one, so a bit high, so difficult one to bring down. But a good series once again for the Saints. And
another two and out.
And that's exactly what they need right now from their defense. They've the offense has responded.
Looks like the Kerry Blues might go for this on third down.
Yeah, it's probably a smart play.
Third and 10, you know what? So
eight and a half minutes to go in the game.
Well, third and 10.
Third and long.
This is going to be a very tough pass for, obviously, Calvin Vaughn to make in these conditions, but they're going for it. Give the Kerry Blues credit.
He's back to pass in the shotgun over the middle.
Oh, and he's incomplete.
Incomplete.
That was Rayshon Smith
once
again.
And that looked like he was come down with a completion for a first down, but he just dropped it moments after he caught that. So that was a nice play, but unfortunately three and out.
So the Saints defense gets some real nice stops the last couple drives.
Yeah, they really picked it up.
They did, and they're going to again take over at midfield. And you know what? They might be breathing a little bit easier now on that Saints sideline because it was a 7-point game with the Kerry Blues having the ball at the 41 before that punt. And that really changed all the momentum of this football game.
Absolutely did. And you've got the Saints back on the field. Looks like the Kerry Blues are down a man with 11 players, so they're bringing another guy out. But the Saints are ready to go again, and there's been another momentum switch. And I say after the tussle there at midfield, things have settled down a little bit. You know, it's
good to see.
Some more clean play once again. And you know, it happens. It's a contact sport, and you get fired up.
Well, you know what exactly? Football, it's a lot of emotions out there, and both these two teams have played the game the right way for the most part today. They both are obviously a lot of intensity, and We saw things boil over a few minutes ago at midfield there, but overall, very well played, clean game, and you got to really respect what St. Mike's has done coming in here and making this a very tight ball game.
Yes, they have.
But that being said, the Saints now a chance to go up by three scores.
Zach Marcus.
Marcus, who's a different play for him. Yeah, that was a little shovel pass to Marcus, and he's got about nine yards.
That was a nice play.
Yep, it was. 9 yards, second and short. And you know what the Saints want to do here? Get that clock to keep going, keep
yes,
it on the ground.
Do.
Seven
yes.
minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Move the chains and get out of here with your win.
That's right. And that's I don't know if we've seen that play yet today, so that's nice to be able to throw something like that out with 7 minutes to go
Pretty
in the fourth
extensive
quarter.
Extensive playbook.
Yeah, it
we
certainly
haven't seen,
is.
I'm sure, a lot of stuff. There's stuff in that playbook that we'll see in later
oh,
weeks,
you're
right.
I'm sure, you're right?
right.
You won't see that until the semifinal
right.
or the final, right?
Oh, boy. Ball. That's a fumble. And Chris Merchant, lucky to get that ball back. It'll bring up third down. And now the Saints, it looks like, are going to
punt.
Punt
team's
yeah.
coming out, yeah.
What happened there?
It's, you know, we had trouble with that this morning as well. That ball gets so wet, and one of those things is pretty slippery down there. But they've been handling this really well, so that's just a mental mistake, I'm sure, on either the center's part or Chris's part. But they'll have to punt away here with 6:53 left in the fourth.
They didn't kill as much clock as I'm
no,
sure they would have liked
not.
To.
No, they did not.
All right, so here we go. The Cary Blues are going to get the ball back. 6:45 to go in the fourth quarter. Saints lead at 38-24. The Saints have the special teams have been pretty good for the Saints, other than
That's
some
right.
issues with some extra points. But you know what? That punt, a lot better than the first punt we saw, where they only got about 20 yards net. This punt will get down to about the 22-yard line, so a long field for the Cary Blues to go here.
Yeah, and I think that was a design play, too. It's, you could hear Coach Gurriel, great punt, when it just angled it off to the
you
side.
You know what, because the last punt
the last
was like
one,
50-yard that's return.
That's right, so
right?
don't give them an so. Opportunity to bring that ball back into Saints territory. Kick it outside and let them work the field. And the defense has been so strong in the last couple of series, indeed the whole game, but the last couple of series, that bury them deep, let the defense go to work.
Well, let's see what the Cary Blues offense can do. Is they've struggled their last couple possessions with the weather. Calvin Vaughn, we know this guy can throw the ball. It's very windy, though, and boy, you know, wind sometimes can be what affects a quarterback more than anything else.
That's right. Back to pass.
He's got
the,
a guy that
flats.
Goes off
no.
his hands. Yeah, that would be Liam Grippo. The ball goes off his hands, and it's an incomplete pass, bringing up second down.
Yeah, he wanted that one for sure.
Short you know, pass. That's a pass that I'm sure that Calvin Vaughn, a very safe call on first down, expects to get 6 or 7 yards
yeah.
out of that.
Yeah, and Grippo's had a good game as well. I mean, perhaps other circumstances he'd be bringing that ball down, but it just trickled off his fingers.
All right, so second down, and again, you're going to see Calvin Vaughn forced to throw the ball here. He does line up in the shotgun formation. And again, we haven't seen Matthew Crocker, who's lined up right in front of us on the right side, yet in this half.
This could be
Let's
it
see
right
if they
here.
Go to him. Nope. Again,
no,
they've been targeting Rayshon Smith, and Smith has been struggling with that ball. A few have gone off his hands in this this half, and he's been the guy who's gotten a lot of the targets, and he's unfortunately for him, but unable to come up with that football.
And that was an interesting choice as well. I mean, it looked like Rayshon went into triple coverage there. And I'll tell you, it's really hard to bring the ball down when you've got he at least had two around him. I thought he had three around him.
I thought that, you know, Crocker in front of us was, well, he had some single coverage there, would have been the intended guy.
I thought so, too. It looked like Crocker was actually wheeling on the outside, and
yep.
he had gained position. So,
well, the St. Mike's Cary Blues forced the punt. This punt,
not a great
not
punt
a good
by
one
any
at
means.
All, no.
And Zach Marcus sheds a tackle, but he's down then just at midfield.
Is there anything else that can maybe ask Zach Marcus to do? Or?
I'm not sure. he seems to be doing quite a bit.
This guy, I think, has
it's
been
pretty impressive.
He's been all over the field today for St. Mike's, and he really is Mr. Everything.
Yeah, he's an impressive player for sure.
All right, so the Saints are going to take over around midfield. Up by two scores, 38-24, 4:56 to go. And again, we'll reiterate the point. You know they're going to want to keep this on the ground, move the clock, get a couple first downs, and really not give the Cary Blues much time
That's
when they
right.
do see the ball
That's
again.
Right. You'll see a good push off the offensive line. good bunch of kids down there. They're going to, if they give the ball to Femi once again, they'll give him a nice hole, I'm sure. But I don't know if you're going to see Chris go to the air too much. And this win just picked up quite dramatically.
Jonathan Femi Cole better be, here we go. He better get used to getting the ball. And he cuts back, and he's going to get
good pursuit
by the Cary Blues defense.
Yeah. And for the people at home, I almost lost the umbrella. Could have taken someone out down below. I've got the two hands on it once again, but this wind is just swirling through here.
Yeah,
it's
tough conditions. Give the coaches, the players a lot of credit.
They're battling.
We're battling the elements. Battling the elements right here at St. Andrews Homecoming.
That's right.
And you know what, though? There's no place I'd rather be.
No,
it's great. It's football. It's been a great football game. And you got to give both schools a lot of credit. Homecoming here at St. Andrews, a lot of fun. A
lot of fun for sure.
All right, so here we go. Second and long now for the St. Andrews Saints, and Chris Merchant is going to throw. There's a flag on the play. And he will be tackled short of the first down marker. So if this flag is on, St. Andrews probably declined. It'll bring up third down. We'll find out.
The wait and see on this one. It looks like potential for offside.
Yeah, they St. Mike's is obviously motioning that the penalty's on St. Andrews.
Refs are talking to the St. Mike's guys. So.
Well, they want to see if they want to make them go second and long or third and short.
Right,
They are declining the penalty, which brings up third down. And we will see the punt team once again for the St. Andrews Saints. If you're a fan of punting, the last couple minutes, you've enjoyed this football game.
Yes, indeed.
We've seen a lot of punting.
Well, I said that really you should just go get yourself a snack and make your way back to the TV because you don't want to miss the action. But it slowed down a little bit, and the conditions have dictated that.
Exactly.
Right?
But you know what? When you're up by two touchdowns, that's fine. You just don't want to turn. Don't make a mistake. Don't turn the ball over and play conservative. And that's what we're seeing right now from Coach Kerr and St. Andrews.
Yeah, it's a smart choice. And Chris Merchant doesn't turn the ball over very often, that's for sure. But these conditions, anything can happen.
All right, so the kick will be fielded.
It's a live ball.
St. Andrews ball. Who else?
Who else
recovers
it? Number 88, Zach Marcus.
Well, the team captain does it all.
Wow.
I was joking with you that what else can he do? You know what? He can recover punts. He can recover muff punts.
That is just impressive.
Well, a member of the 88 club. I know Len had a chance recently to meet Michael Irvin, who's the head of the 88 club in the NFL.
Yes.
I think Len's got his own version of the 88 club on the St. Andrews Saints.
I'll tell you, Zach Marcus is, he's a gamer in and of itself, but he's making a name for himself if he hasn't already done it.
Well,
he's out there.
Yeah, he's unbelievable.
He's making plays all over the field.
All right, so Chris Merchant back under center, and there's 2:45 to go. The Saints have an opportunity here to really milk this clock and get out of here with the win. And that
Femi
is Femi Cole,
up
the ball carrier.
Up the gut.
It's a gain of three maybe on the play.
Just grinding it out at this point.
And we'll see if, I guess you're going to see right now the St. Mike's use their timeouts, try to get the ball back here. But uphill battle if you're St. Mike's,
very
down by
so.
Two touchdowns, 2:35 to go.
Saints D really stepped it up there earlier in the fourth quarter when they needed to, and when the Cary Blues were pressuring, they were able to stop them. And that's changed the momentum in the game.
Well, there'll be some things to clean up for St. Andrews after this game, but overall, you got to be happy with how things have gone. 2 minutes to go, 2:10 to be exact. And Chris Merchant, under center, will hand the ball off again. Femi Cole,
Femi
the ball
Cole.
Carrier.
Looks like
Femi
he's going
Cole
to the house. Femi
to the
Cole.
House.
Touchdown.
Four touchdowns for
wow.
Femi Cole.
Number 28. That is just impressive.
And that will seal the deal for the Saints on homecoming as Femi Cole reaches Pater for the fourth time in the ballgame. 44-24 Saints over the Cary Blues with 2:03 to go in the fourth quarter.
Just a tremendous run by Femi Cole. I mean, just puts his head down and drives. I mean, he had one or two defenders to break free of, but he's just a horse down there. It's impressive.
Yeah, he really is. They got a player in Femi Cole, Jonathan Femi Cole, the real deal. And now they're going to try and Chris Merchant. Chris Merchant's been the guy who's been forced to kick for St. Andrews, and he has unfortunately for the Saints, they've had a lot of bad snaps. They got to work on this extra point.
I think I think they really do. I think it could be front and center on Monday or Tuesday's practice.
I think so.
I mean, there's lots of good going on out here for both squads, quite frankly. But the you're right. The Saints have some stuff to clean up. But all in all, it's been very impressive.
Yeah, I don't know. We haven't been able to get to the bottom of what happened with the Saints kicking game, if there was an injury. But you got to figure they probably don't want Chris Merchant kicking those extra points.
At times you want the quarterback as the holder, but you rarely see him as the kicker. But then again, Chris Merchant seems to be the guy to do any number of things. Now, mind you, the holder is Zach Marcus, so, you know, it's a bit of a 1-2 combination.
Speaking of being able to do anything, Zach Marcus is – prove that he can do that as well. Does Zach Marcus play defense? Like, I haven't have we seen 88 out there on defense?
You know what? I haven't noticed him, but I'm sure he's out there somewhere.
All right. Well, the kickoff is muffed by St. Mike's. They do get the ball, and they will start from their own 25. Yep. 1:57 to go. Saints lead the Cary Blues 44-24. Homecoming for St. Andrews will barring a miracle by St. Mike's, will end positively with a victory. The Cary Blues have to feel pretty good about a lot of things about this football game, too.
Agreed.
They were very competitive. The passing game, I thought, was outstanding other than those two late picks in the second quarter. And then the wind sort of picked up, which, unfortunately for them, took away a lot of what they were able to do. But, again, Calvin Vaughn had himself quite the game for the Cary Blues.
Yeah, he did. And you know what? There was a real momentum shift as well. They came out in the second half playing extraordinarily well and got within one touchdown. I'll tell you, the Cary Blues fans were fired up. The players were fired up. Then there was another momentum switch, and the Saints took
that
over
punt, and
things changed after that.
All right, so it will
back
be Calvin Vaughn in shotgun, and he's got a guy, and he's got about 5 yards on the play. The pass is complete to number 34, Adrian Cole. All right, so 1:50 to go. Saints up by 20. You'd expect maybe the Cary Blues will be going deep a couple times here, trying to score once and really leave the field feeling very good about themselves if they can go with the momentum of scoring a touchdown. They got 1:35 to do so. And they are going to have their quarterback in shotgun as Calvin Vaughn lines up. And we do have to wonder why Matthew Crocker was not a bigger part of this offense.
Yeah, he was really such a gamer.
Well, here he
the
is right
half.
There. There's Crocker, and actually right on cue, the ball actually goes off his hands. Nicely defended by the Saints.
Yeah. Nice player. Not sure why he hasn't gotten the ball in the second half, but you know what? He had an impressive first half, to say the least.
Sure did.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? We talked about it, though, that they would have to make adjustments on how to defend Crocker, and maybe they did, and that's why you didn't see him be a big part of the offense in the second half. But they are gonna punt here on third down, and you never want to run up the score. So I think you know, if you're St. Mike's, you don't want to be throwing an incomplete pass here and give the Saints a chance from the 30-yard line to score again with 1 minute left.
Yeah.
So punt coming here for the Cary Blues, and again, not a very good one. But these are really tough conditions.
Yeah, they
to
really
kick
are,
in.
And it looked. It looked as though it looks as though it was a bad snap as well, fairly low. And
1 minute to go in the football game.
1 minute to go, and you know, things are still pretty calm out there. There's a couple bit of pushing and shoving out there, but it's all right. You know, they
seems like a Saint though is banged up on the play.
Not sure who is down. I was looking at a incident that was happening over here by the 35-yard line, and it looks like someone.
I believe it's Duncan Roberts, the linebacker, who is a little shaken up on the play. Obviously, hoping he's okay, as he's being attended to right now by the coaches and the medical staff.
No doubt, Duncan's folks will be watching from Nova Scotia. Duncan's one of our boarders. Hate to see him down like that. I was one of my boarding students when I was housemaster in Flavelle last year, and hope he's all right. It looks like he took quite a lick.
Yeah, hopefully it's only the wind being knocked out of him or something like that. Yeah, not a lot of really information, obviously, we can give you right now. We don't know what they're looking at. And all we can hope for is that Duncan is okay. And I believe I saw 55. I you know, I got decent eyesight. We are quite a ways away, but.
Apologies if we got it wrong, but I was again watching a bit of a minor situation going on over here at 35, and I missed that completely, unfortunately.
Well, they attended Duncan. We believe Duncan Robertson.
Yeah, Coach Shrimpton's down talking to him as well, and the physio staff is there as well, so that he'll be in good hands without a doubt. 1 minute to go in the game. Still a little breezy.
Well, you hate to see something like this happen.
Yeah,
at
you
any
do.
Point of a game, but especially, you know, late in the game when you've been able to at least not have any casualties from injuries or anything like that. And something like this can obviously put a real damper on what has been a fun day. But we just hope for the best, and we hope it's nothing serious. And we hope it, like I said, just the wind knocked out of him or something.
Coach,
like
it looks like he's getting up now. That's a good sign.
Yeah.
It's a good sign. Coach Gurr is just chatting with the St. Mike's head coach right now. Again, the good level of collegiality between both groups here. And you do hate to see this. You know, in any sport, it's tough. And you wait for him to get up and hopefully walk off the field by his own own power. And
absolutely. And the clock is. They're going to call the game.
They're going to call the game.
This is the game. The final score. The Saints do win it, 44-24.
That's a good call. I think that's a good call, and that's obviously what Coach Gurr and the St. Mike's head coach were talking about. And again, that says a lot about the respect they have for one another and the injury on the field with 1 minute to go, and excellent call.
All right, so the final score, the Saints do win homecoming at St. Andrews, 44-24. The injury does put a bit of a damper on
it. Does,
we are going to want to get the information as to what exactly the injury is. And we obviously are hoping and praying for the best. But the Saints win it, 44-24, the final.
Yes.
A nice job by the Saints in the fourth quarter. Yeah. They were only up by seven, and the Cary Blues had the ball. And they were able to make two nice plays defensively, forcing a Cary Blue punt. The punt went over the kicker's head, and the Saints took over. Very, very short field position. They were able to score and win that football game. And unfortunately, the player's still down.
Yeah, and sadly, he's just trying to get him up there. And I'll tell you, it was a real game changer at that very moment, but it was a heck of a good football game, admittedly. It really, really was. And you can see the quarterback of the Cary Blues, the revered Calvin Vaughn. I mean, the coaching staff for St. Andrews are giving him props because he really did have a solid game.
All right, for everyone here who braved the elements with us, our cameramen, our directors, our floor directors, I want to thank everyone. I want to thank Dave Stewart as well, the head coach of the junior football team.
It's my
great
pleasure.
Great job, really enjoyed it, Dave. And all the best for the St. Andrews Saints as the season continues. 44-24 the final. Saints win on homecoming. For Dave Stewart, this has been Eric Cohen, and this has been Saints Homecoming.